News the Aggies, San Antonio's Sports Center.
It is mock draft season, and the NFL Network's Peter Schrager has released one that has the Cowboys taking University of Texas wide receiver Xavier Worthy at number 24. I know it, right? Hey, he's the fastest guy in the world, right? We got some playoff basketball starting tonight out west. New Orleans takes on the Lakers, and that's followed up by Sacramento and Golden State. That'll be fun.
Joe Reinagle.
That's the third time in seven seasons the San Antonio Spurs are the NBA champions.
Jason Minnitz.
They go back to big day as Super Bowl champions. Dallas 52, Buffalo 17.
It's the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minnix.
Wow.
Wow, wow. Wow.
Wow.
Here we go.
Wow.
Here we go. Squirrel.
Sorry, I was distracted.
Here we go.
Understandable.
Yes. My goodness. That Malika Andrews?
That is. You just now realized?
Well, no, I didn't realize that, but that's quite an outfit she has on today.
Yes, it is.
Very
bright.
It's very bright, yeah, but it leaves nothing to the imagination.
Well, that's not true.
Well, it does, I mean, it's form-fitting.
Yes.
That's what I should say.
Yes.
Yeah.
Leaves plenty to the imagination.
Well, sure, but...
I mean, you're caught imagining right now. You dirty old man.
Wow.
What a way to start the show.
Well, I guess it's not my fault.
Well, what do you mean?
It's ESPN's fault. The hell?
Good Lord. Can we start the over? We just start over. I mean, just start over.
Oh, my goodness. No, that's...
Joe Reinagle.
That's the third time in seven seasons. The San Antonio Spurs are the NBA champions.
Jason Minnitz.
They go back to big day as Super Bowl champions. Dallas 52, Buffalo 17.
It's the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. His wife has been out of town all of one day, and look what's happened to him.
Two, actually.
Who's counting? I'm Jason Minnitz. Well, when did she leave? She left Sunday, right?
Sunday, yes.
Okay. So it's
2 days.
Sure.
She won't be back until tomorrow afternoon.
Until tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah.
Okay.
Looking forward to that.
I mean...
Tiger
Woods apparently gave up sex for a couple of weeks getting ready for the Masters, and it didn't help.
Didn't do him any good, did it?
I mean, he was a frustrated driver out there at the Masters. His putter wasn't working either at the Masters.
No, it wasn't. Yeah, there's all kinds of stories about Tiger. Some pro golfers accusing him of using steroids and performance-enhancing substances. Which I don't know if that's illegal on the PGA Tour. Honestly, I don't know. But I wouldn't blame the guy. I mean, after all he's been through. Geez, I mean, if that helps.
But he's always been in shape.
He's in shape. There's no doubt.
He's always been in shape.
Yeah.
So I don't know what they test for. Who knows? I don't know. Golfer trying to make a name for himself. Who was the golfer? I didn't read this article.
I'll have to go back. I read it this morning and then kind of forgot
golfer
about
that,
it. And...
That sticks with you because he's one of those types.
Yeah, he's not. I quite honestly never heard of the guy.
Well,
so
that's how most people are with the PGA types.
Yeah, apparently. Not doing well.
Mm, neither are you.
No,
the
I'm
hell,
doing just fine.
What's wrong with you,
Joe? I have no problem. I'm good. Yeah, I stumbled a little bit through the Sports Center. That happens. Normally, Pledge will fix all that.
Well, it's live. You can't
but
fix it.
But when I'm live,
yes.
Yeah, you
do
can't
it live.
Fix it. You know, I should probably.
Well, I mean, look, I think we could all stumble over reading a Cowboys mock draft that has Xavier Worthy going to the Cowboys in the first round. All this talk about a fat guy, as long as center, tackle, it doesn't matter. But a speedy wide receiver.
Yeah, I'm in.
You know,
let's do it. I will talk you into it.
If the Cowboys do that, it's not going to surprise me one bit.
Of course not.
And that's the last thing they need right now.
Well, that's not true.
It's true.
It's not true.
It's the last thing they need.
Not the last thing they need. It's not.
Yeah, it is.
It really isn't.
They're in good shape wide receiver-wise compared to...
Are they really?
Yes.
Are they really?
Well, you got CeeDee Lamb and Brandon Cooks first and foremost.
Well, all
and
right.
And then you've got that dude who... You may make it or not.
You got a couple of Jalens that I could get rid of because I would rather have an Xavier than a Jalen. Do you want a Jalen Tolbert? Can I offer you up a Jalen Cooper? Or there's also a Jalen Brooks on the Cowboys roster right now. You got three Jalens that play wide receiver, and all three combined aren't as good as Xavier Worthy.
You got a Turpin out there, too, who has been known to play a little wide receiver.
Yes,
so.
And again, he's going to be a great kick return guy.
Well, I mean, look, just because Worthy's fast doesn't make him Tyreek Hill all of a sudden.
Well, you watch Longhorn football, right?
Sure.
Okay. Just saying.
I'm just saying, is that still college? I'm just wondering.
Well,
that is still college football, right?
I mean, a first-round pick might be a pay cut for the kid. I don't know.
But that is considered college. A step below the NFL, is it not? I mean, I'm just checking. Last time I checked, there's a big jump between college and pros.
Well, doesn't that go for everybody that we're talking about with
sure,
the draft?
Absolutely.
All right, then your argument is mute. You're arguing with the wall to argue.
To take a guy, a wide receiver in the first round, if you're the Dallas Cowboys, just seems kind of dumb.
Well, again, right now you've got CeeDee Lamb and Brandon Cooks.
Uh-huh.
You add an Xavier Worthy.
Sure.
The reason where I can talk myself into this, not being a Longhorn homer,
uh-huh.
because I still want a fat guy.
Well, you're a Cowboy homer too.
Hard to get excited about a fat guy. But when you look at the wide receiver salaries escalating, could wide receivers become the next running back where, dude, we'll draft you? And we're not going to pay you that kind of money. I'll just go draft another one because CeeDee Lamb, he's got 1 year left at $17 million, which isn't enough. He's going to get close to 30 on his new contract. Or CeeDee Lamb, you got 1 year left in Dallas, and now we've got Xavier Worthy because we're just going to replace you with a rookie that will be on a rookie deal. When you look at wide receiver salaries, the way they have ballooned, could that be going the route of the running back? You know, Jerry gets hammered all the time for the Zeke deal, and running backs don't get paid anymore. Could he be on the forefront
some
of
running
doing
backs
this
do,
with wide
actually.
Receivers?
I mean, there were some running backs that actually got paid this year.
Yeah, well, but not like Zeke was.
Well,
again, it didn't start with Zeke. I mean, he had some other running backs in that time frame that
Todd Gurley, I think, started that train.
Well, I mean, you know, he was up there. And he was, he got the big one, and then Zeke.
So let me just make sure I understand you. So you're saying
here we go.
We draft Xavier Worthy and get rid of CeeDee Lamb.
That's exactly what I said. It's not complicated.
Wow.
It's not complicated.
Wow.
I'm not saying it's what I would do.
I see. See, your bias is showing. Get rid of the Oklahoma dude and bring in a Texas guy.
Hook him. That said, I'm not saying I would do it. I'm not even saying that I'm in favor of it, but if the Cowboys were to do it and they were to say, this is the reason why, it makes sense.
Okay.
Because wide receivers, they're all over the place. And there's more and more wide receivers that are coming out. It's a passing league. You go to the high school level, you got wide receivers, college level, wide receivers, NFL level. Do you really want to pay a wide receiver 30 some odd million dollars a year when you're in a salary cap world? And you get Steven. Well, we got to play Micah. We got to pay Dak. Do we got to pay CD? Or can I replace him pretty easily? Of all of them, wide receivers might be the easiest to replace.
Well, that's going to be the drama of the draft.
Well,
and it's funny because that's part of it. But, you know, on Get Up this morning, you know, they're talking about the Dak dilemma.
Yeah.
And what do the Cowboys do? And just wait and see. Could a Michael Penix might be there? Would the Cowboys do that?
We'll see. And if Michael Penix or Bo Nix is there at 24, then you know. Well,
they'll be there at 24. I'm not sure either one of those guys worth a first-round pick.
But if the Cowboys take a quarterback high in the draft, we will know what their plan is with Dak Prescott. Mm-hmm. If they don't take a quarterback high in the draft, then, you know, Dak's going to get his extension at some point.
I love you, Dak.
Yes.
Oh, man.
What the drama. What are we, a week and 2 days from the draft?
Yes.
Is it 9 days? 9 days.
Wow.
All the spaghetti's against the wall. Let's do it.
Of course.
Let's do it.
It's what we do.
Yes.
Xavier Ward. And then I saw that. I'm going, come on.
Well, see, and here's the thing.
Schrager.
Here's the thing.
Hasn't he been on hiatus?
No.
He's smoking and drinking too much.
No, he's not Mike Tyson. Here's the thing. Because it is Peter Schrager.
Uh-huh.
And he is so well connected. And even says in an article, this isn't what I would do. This is what I'm hearing. He is one of those draft mock guys that you kind of pay attention to because of how well connected they are.
Uh-huh.
You know, this isn't, you know, like for me, like Dane Bugler from The Athletic is the best. Then you got the Kuipers of the world that have been doing it forever. And he'll have 78,000 mock drafts out and we'll be able to say, well, in my 14th one, I'll go there. Daniel Jeremiah is another good one. Schrager doesn't do a lot of mock drafts.
No, he doesn't.
And so, but historically, when he does these, he does it with the idea of, this is what I'm hearing through all the GMs and the different people that I'm talking to. So it does carry a little bit more credibility than this guy that works at this radio station put together his mock draft. Or, you know.
Well, you don't like mine? Is that what you're saying?
Well, the Cowboys, Joe, aren't not going to take a punter in the first round.
Damn it.
I know that's what your mock draft had. They're not going to do that. So, no, your mock has zero credibility.
Yeah, I'm a good judge of talent, though. I mean, we've seen that. Well, with Aubrey and Ferguson, I mean, that's a pretty good judge.
You are a fantastic judge of talent when you judge guys that are already in training camp. You weren't telling me about Aubrey before the Cowboys signed him, saying this is the guy they should go get.
Obviously, the Cowboys weren't sold on Ferguson because they go out and make a terrible mistake at number two last year in the draft.
Yes.
And some Schoonmaker dude who's...
Schoonmaker.
Yeah.
Yes.
Look, last year was a horrible draft for the Cowboys.
In more ways than one.
Yes.
In more ways than one.
I don't have a lot of faith in them. And if they start this thing out with an Xavier Worthy as the number one pick, you're like,
all right,
what the hell?
But let's go back to, since Xavier Worthy is a wide receiver and the Cowboys don't necessarily need a wide receiver. Was it the 20 draft or 21 draft? Whatever. A couple years ago. 4 years ago. So the 2020 draft.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
They didn't need a wide receiver, but a CeeDee Lamb fell to them.
And then
they got a Trayvon Diggs in the second round.
Uh-huh.
You got two Pro Bowl players, cornerstones, big contract types that are on your roster right now for the Dallas Cowboys.
Okay.
Right? And typically speaking, they have been very good at the draft and post-draft. They are coming off a horrible draft where their guys did not make the immediate impact that they were expecting them to make. So does one bad draft over the last several wipe away all the trust? Because you literally just said that. So one draft that was a swing and a miss, at least for immediate impact.
Well, the Cowboys, you got to say there's a little fortune in there. And I'm not saying that's a bad thing. Micah Parsons, extremely fortunate that a couple of cornerbacks went right before him because that's what the Cowboys were going to do.
Yes.
They needed a cornerback when they drafted Trayvon Diggs.
Yes.
So that was a legit pick for need in the second round.
So when
CD was not. They were fortunate.
Well, I think everybody in the draft that isn't picking at number one is fortunate. Uh-huh. The Texans were fortunate last year picking at number two.
Davis Mills, a hero of the Houston Texans.
But again, though,
I don't know why he doesn't have a statue.
I mean, retire the jersey.
Yes.
But yeah, everybody's a little bit fortunate. It just depends on who's talking about them on the draft. They're either really good at what they do and, you know, with their fortune, they still made the right picks of everybody that was available. I mean, yeah, they wanted somebody else and ended up with Micah Parsons, but they could have taken 50 some odd other people there.
They
but they took Micah Parsons.
Sure.
But you're just going to give them fortune.
It's fortunate. Extremely.
Uh-huh. They weren't fortunate last year. Diving into what those boys were talking about on draft night, we'll bring some memory to your memory as we continue here on the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Here's something memory. Stevens Roofing. You got any problems with your roof at all? Stevens Roofing is the name to remember. And keep in mind, storms are coming. They've been here already. It's springtime in San Antonio and South Texas. And that means that the hailstorms, the thunderstorms, the wind, the rain, all of that stuff is coming. You know it is. It happens every year. want to make sure that roof is okay. Want to make sure it's going to be able to stand up to whatever Mother Nature has to throw at it. Look, we've had some hail already, and if you think maybe you've got some damage, call Stevens Roofing. Don't go with one of these fly-by-night companies that just come around and knock on your door after a storm, and they do a horrible job and leave. Stevens Roofing's not doing that. They've been in business here in San Antonio and South Texas for a long, long time. They're not going anywhere. They stand behind their work. When you're in the market for repairs, a replacement roof, an upgrade, or just an inspection to make sure that everything's okay, work with Stevens Roofing, an experienced team that brings local roots, value, and a vast knowledge of the craft to every job. Stevens Roofing, let me give you that phone number, 210-785-0994. You can also get them online at stevensroofing.net. But give them a call. Let them check out your roof, 210-785-0994.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, we look back to the first play-ins. We get more tonight, and also the Spurs draft history. Looks like a 5 pick all the way through an 8. We'll look at the history of the Spurs in that order.
Plus, the NFL draft begins next Thursday night. Who are the Dallas Cowboys going to take in the first round? Who are the Houston Texans going to take when it's all said and done? I might convince Rob to do a mock draft. You don't want to miss it. The Morning Huddle starts at 6.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ. Morning 6 to 10 on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Injuries happen, and when they do, skip the ER and get to the OrthoNow Injury Clinic by TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine. OrthoNow provides walk-in care for injuries like broken bones, dislocations, sprains, and strains. Conveniently located in the Cory area with extended hours Monday through Saturday with on-site x-ray casting and bracing, OrthoNow has everything you need to treat your injury, and best of all, no urgent care or emergency room copay. Learn more online at TSAOG.com.
We all hear the radio ads about the IRS. They tell you to be afraid, to be scared, and they try to frighten you into calling. I'm not here to do that. Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000, $50,000, or $500,000, we have a solution. It doesn't matter if you're sitting in your car, at work, or with your kids, no matter where you are, call now. 800-575-2706. Don't lose hope. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS. There is zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. Our passion is taxes and helping individuals fix their IRS problems. We have a 5-star rating on Google and an A+ with the Better Business Bureau. You don't need to be afraid of the IRS any longer. End your tax nightmare today by visiting us online at TRA.com or call 800-575-2706. That's 800-575-2706. Tax Relief Advocates. Real solutions for real people.
Are you ready to party with a purpose? Pace to the Northside is Thursday, April 18th at the beautiful Security Service Event Center. This elevated fiesta event for foodies includes on-site covered parking, entertainment, unlimited tastings from over 30 premier restaurants, countless curated wines and craft beers, hosted by Brighton Center, presented by HEB. Purchase tickets at tasteofthenorthside.org. Proceeds benefit Brighton Center, the largest nonprofit in San Antonio, serving children with disabilities through pediatric therapy and education initiatives. Have you gotten your hands on Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds at HEB yet? Southern Recipe Small Batch offers big, bold flavors like hot honey, spicy dill, and sea salt and cracked black pepper. Bonus, you're going to love the low-carb, high-protein crunch. Turn snack time from ordinary to extraordinary with flavorful pork rinds. Pick up your favorite flavors of Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds at HEB today.
We're here with Jose of the Gomez Law Firm. Jose, tell us a little about what makes the Gomez Law Firm different from all the other law firms in our area.
You know, we pride ourselves as being an open line of communications. We don't have an automated service. You're not going to ever dial our phone number and get some robot on the other line. You're always going to get a person 24/7. Our principal office is here in San Antonio. And we don't only say principal office because our main office is here. We say it because, again, Mr. Gomez was born and raised here, practicing law here in San Antonio in his community for almost 50 years. There are not many attorneys that can say that. If you've been injured, if you've been involved in an accident, you've been involved in a car wreck, call the Gomez Law Firm. We've been around for almost 50 years, and we're not going anywhere.
If you have been injured in an accident or hit by a company vehicle, then you need to visit joegomezlaw.com.
And remember, Gomez Law fights.
The Jim Rome Show.
Hey, Jim Rome here. And back in the military city of San Antonio.
Weekdays at noon on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minix. If you did some grilling over the last couple of days, make sure you upload those great meat photos from your grill to sasportstar.com, the Grilling with the Blitz page, because every Thursday we judge meat and give away a $50 gift card to Tri-County Meat Market, which we will do this Thursday, judging meat at one of the best food events of the year, Taste of the North Side, my favorite fiesta event.
It only makes sense to do that on Thursday. That's how I went by Tri-County last night.
Uh-huh.
Late. They close at 7 during the week, and so I was afraid. But I'm a bachelor for the last couple. So, steak sounded good. So, just kind of a bachelor kind of thing. You go, and I got me a steak, grilled it up last night, sat on my back porch, and just chilled out. It was great.
So you're home alone.
Yep.
You're bacheloring it.
I am.
And you still went home and grilled a steak.
I did.
Yeah, you could have got a pizza. You could have something to drive through.
Yeah.
You went and grilled a steak for yourself.
It just sounded good.
Uh-huh.
It just sounded really good. And so that's what I wanted. And, it was a nice night, really nice outside. So it was perfect.
You want to tell the people what you were really doing?
What was I really doing?
Well, we went to lunch today.
Oh, yeah. I'll tell you what I was doing. I was watching The Voice.
The Voice.
The Voice. I did watch. I saw Caitlin Clark. I watched about the first 10 picks of the WNBA draft.
Yeah.
I saw that. And Maggie and I are kind of into The Voice right now.
Okay.
I like the competition going on, and it was good.
The Voice, huh?
The Voice.
I haven't seen The Voice in I don't know how long. Let's see. Erica will be 26. She graduated high school in 2016.
Has it been on that long?
And I only know about The Voice because Adam Levine used to be on there.
Shelton, they're no longer on there.
Well, I know, but we used to have to watch when Adam Levine was on because
of
the Maroon 5.
Right.
It's
not Maroon 5. It's like, oh, he's hot.
Dude, that's
what the women are saying.
It's Adam Levine. Everybody has, for my daughter, it's Adam Levine. I don't get it.
You go
see him in concert and she sits there and cries the whole time. I don't get it, but whatever. I didn't know The Voice was still on.
It's still on, going strong. Have you heard of Dan and Shay? Dan and Shay.
Sounds like a bad morning show in Des Moines.
Obviously, you haven't heard of them. Reba McEntire,
I've heard of Reba.
John Legend?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, they're judges. And Chance the Rapper.
Well, of course.
What he was on with Bieber.
Yeah.
Right? They had a little song together.
Did you just Google who was on there?
I forgot John Legend.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I knew all the others, but I forgot John.
Who the hell is Dan and Shay?
They're country, kind of.
They're country?
I guess you'd call them country. They're more popish than country.
Well, bubblegum country is kind of the thing that you're going to hear now on country music.
But they had a bunch of hits a couple years ago, and so they're living life off of that.
I don't know them.
Yeah, well.
Was music good? I mean, I'm generally into live music, but
it's more of a kind of a. Make-out music kind of stuff. You know what I mean?
Make-out music.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're home alone watching make-out kind of music sort of stuff.
They didn't sing. They're judges.
Well, I know they're judges.
They didn't sing.
But the people were singing.
No, Dan
and Shay do the make-out songs.
No, they do. Yeah, that's what they're famous for.
Oh, I thought that's what you were watching last night on The Voice.
No, you're home alone listening to
some really good...
Home Alone. Some really good people on that thing.
Oh, yeah, it's incredible. Uh-huh. There's a lot of talent in this world.
Yeah.
So
that's what I was doing, and I'm not ashamed of it, not embarrassed at all.
None.
Had a great steak watching that.
Uh-huh.
Nice glass of wine. It was a great night.
I'm just glad we didn't get feet pictures.
Well, you didn't. Yeah.
Thank God. Home Alone, watching make-out music, eating a steak by yourself with wine, and all of a sudden, foot porn.
There's always tonight.
Please don't. Please don't. No, nobody in our group chat wants to see your toes.
I've only heard that from you. I haven't heard it from anybody else.
RJ Ochoa?
Haven't heard that from him.
Yes,
no.
You have.
No.
Yes, you have. Pledge, are you looking for a feet pick tonight from Joe Reinagle?
I've told him no like 30 times. He's obviously 30 forgotten times. About
at least 30. He's only sent like three pictures.
Not even three.
No, three.
Two.
But he's threatened multiple times.
Well, he does threaten.
I'd hold that over y'all's head.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you be careful, man. I'm going to whip this out, take a picture, and send it to you. Socks off.
Oh, man.
Good Lord. So, you know, we started watching last night on Netflix, Ripley. And it's an interesting series. Uh-huh. I've only watched like two episodes. It's one of those limited series things. Because I've been watching Loudermilk, but I just wanted to see something new. We are getting into that time of year where we're all going to have to like, hey, what show are you watching? What show are you watching?
Right.
Because I need a new grouping of shows. Loudermilk is incredible. And I don't understand how this show has been on for a couple of years. And I only started hearing about it a couple of months ago. But, you know, with basketball and hockey almost over, it is almost to that point when I don't know how things are at your guys' house. I can have a baseball game on the side TV, but I'm not going to be able to watch baseball at home every night.
Right.
You know,
right.
I mean, you know, and depending on who's in the NBA playoffs and how many nights a week, because it's really kind of her season. Well, she doesn't necessarily control the remote, as I say that out loud, but
she must be at work.
Oh, of course she is. but it's a lot more of, do we really have to watch another game? Do we really, you know, no, she understands big time playoff games.
Well,
but
like tonight, there's no issue. I mean, tonight's going to be a great night. You got two basketball games.
Two play-in games.
I can't wait for those.
Yeah, play-in games. And they're not even really playoff games. These are play-in games. Dude,
well, the early game, you know, whoever loses still has a chance, right? I mean, they can still have a chance to get in. But what I don't understand, and I'm hearing this again, and I don't know why. Is it the arrogance? Is it, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the LeBron James-itis. But why are all these people suggesting, well, the Lakers are just going to lay down tonight against the Pelicans and, you know, so they can get, like they're going to lose on purpose tonight and then just miraculously beat the Warriors or the Kings without any trouble. I mean, it makes no sense to me.
It doesn't. It really doesn't. But New Orleans is at home tonight. It's the early game, 6:30 on TNT. Are we carrying these games on our? No, not here. Not on 12:50. All right. See, they're so big at ESPN. Whatever, boys. But it should. I mean, both those. I mean, Lakers, Pelicans, and then Warriors, Kings. Both should be really good games. Now, the idea of what you're hearing in all these, you know, pundits talking about the Lakers laying down is because Denver owns them.
Sure.
And the Lakers have done really well against Oklahoma City. So are they going to try to lose a game to set up a more favorable matchup?
But that's what I mean.
It doesn't make sense, right?
You're assuming, yeah, we'll just blow this game tonight against the Pelicans and then the Kings or the Warriors, no problem. We'll win that easy.
Yeah.
And they just put that plan right in place. No problem.
Well, I mean, now
that's just arrogant as hell.
Well, it is arrogant as hell. And it's not necessarily true. But if you're the Lakers, do you try, all right, let's lose to New Orleans and have a game that sets us up to face Oklahoma City as opposed to getting fed to the Wolves and swept and embarrassed by Denver? Would you rather lose in the play-in scenario then play four more games when you could be in Cabo already? I mean, there, you know, an extra week of work when you know you're not going to win. What would you do?
Well, I mean,
I know you would take the lazy way out. Like, all right, well, look, 1-2 Cabo, let's go.
Well, me, because I'm not an athlete. If I was a professional basketball player, you know, I'd still want to win.
Well,
you know, I don't know, but
your chances of beating Denver are none.
Oh, you don't know that.
You're not going to beat Denver in a series.
You don't know that.
We do know that.
No, we don't.
We really do.
We don't know that.
We know that. I mean,
game. Why don't I just crown Denver as the champions of the West right now?
Why we play the game. That's, I mean, you're right.
Denver just has a free pass all the way to the NBA Finals.
Well, they got a free pass over the Lakers. They can't beat those guys.
Well, it looks like the Lakers beat them twice this year. Why couldn't they beat them?
Well, I don't know about your math, but 2-8 over the last couple of years. I think they're they're 0-8 in their last 8 matchups, including last year in the playoffs.
So they're due. I mean, they're due, right?
Convince yourself, Ryan Engel. Well, go for it.
What I just don't understand how they think everybody just thinks the Lakers can just, you know, turn it on whenever they want. What are they? The 8th seed? 7th seed? 8th seed? What are the Lakers?
They're in the play-in.
Okay.
So on the road, they've been on the road in the play-in.
They've been great all year, so they can just determine when they win and when they lose. That makes absolutely no sense to me.
Well, it doesn't, and I don't think that's what they're talking about.
But everybody's talking about it.
Well, because of this.
I know. That's LeBron James-itis, because they just think LeBron can do whatever he wants. He'll call Adam Silver and say, hey, we're going to lose this game tonight. So make sure the officials are on our side tomorrow. Friday, whenever they play again. Oh,
that would mess with the integrity of the game. We just don't do that.
It's LeBron James.
But the mindset of Laker fan wants this route.
Well, good for them.
I mean, it's no different. Remember back in the day when the Spurs would win?
Uh-huh.
And you're playing the seeding matchup and like, man, I'd rather be here and face them than here. And Pop would say it doesn't matter. But we would all sit here on Sports Talk Radio talking about this. And, you know, you're the big sports anchor at Channel 5, and you'd come on the show with, you know, and we would all talk about those things because you're trying to create the best matchup possible.
Well, sure, but
that's what the Lakers are doing.
I don't think I ever remember saying, you know, the Spurs should lose this game so they could have this game. I don't think I ever said that. Not once, or not even think about it.
Yeah. Yeah. There's times where we tried to avoid these guys or those guys.
Uh-huh.
You know, I mean,
back when the Spurs were actually good,
yes,
it didn't matter, because it really didn't matter. And the only way they would lose is like a freak accident to Monta Ginobili or
snapping his arm, right? In a
something like
game.
That. So it,
then
you know,
the 8-seeded Grizzlies beat the top seeded Spurs.
Those were what we thought about. Okay. Not once did I ever have the arrogance to say, "Well, the Lakers should lose this game on purpose because the Kings or the Warriors." That's just a party. No problem. We can win that game. Easy.
Mm-hmm. So Golden State and Sacramento have the late game tonight, 9:00 on TNT.
Uh-huh.
Lakers and New Orleans, the early game on TNT.
Well, obviously the Lakers are going to lose.
Well, we don't know that.
Well, they're going to lose.
I mean, they might do it on purpose.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, but we're going to watch.
Yeah. I'll be watching.
We'll be watching.
And I hate both of those teams. So, I mean, I don't know what the hell I'm going to do.
You hate the Pelicans?
I'm not a Pelicans fan.
Why?
Well, they're New Orleans, first of all.
There we go.
That's one reason.
They're creepy looking mascot.
Well, that too. So I don't like either one of those teams.
All right.
I'll be pulling for Steph Curry and Bunch, though, in the late game.
And Bunch.
Steph's Bunch.
Why do you hate Sacramento?
I don't.
Okay.
I'm a big fan of Steph Curry, though.
All right.
I like Steph.
Let's talk Cowboys. More things that Joe doesn't know.
Are they going to lose on purpose, too?
They're trying. I listen to you.
You ain't kidding, man. I mean,
they're not doing anything to win, so they must be trying to lose. Let's talk some Cowboys coming up. Talk about what the Cowboys were talking last year on the clock in the first round.
Interesting
and
stuff.
And apply it to what we're looking at this year. Coming up here on the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. There are those two play-in games tonight in the NBA. Got some hockey on, some baseball as well. You're looking for a place to go watch those games on a great Tuesday. Get into the Roop up there at 281 and Redland Road with those three massive 170-inch screens and TVs all around. Over the last decade, the Roop Hub has proven the place to go watch any big game, any big event, any big fight. There's some big fights coming up as well, so make sure you plan on being at the Roop Hub. And when you get to the Roop Hub, get there hungry because the food is fantastic. They have the biggest and best wings in town, about 15 different burgers on the menu, including the original Wimby burger. I love the fried shrimp over there. They've got great salads, I'm told, great appetizers, I know. And that kitchen is open late till 2 a.m. every day with the full menu available. The Roop Hub has happy hour weekdays from 11 to 6. Great for lunch, great for dinner, great for late at night, and the best place to watch a game. Just down from the big blind, the Roop Hub, right next to the Angry Elephant there at 281 in Redland Road. We'll see you at the Roo.
It's the 2024 NFL Draft on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
With the 24th pick, the Dallas Cowboys select
April 25th, 26th, and 27th. Join 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star for this year's NFL Draft, live from Detroit.
I love the tenacity and the aggression with which he plays. He is a mauler.
Who do the Cowboys and Texans pick? Does Jerry make a splash? Who goes number one? And who's the next Mr. Irrelevant?
The Houston Texans select C.J. Stroud.
We don't ever want to pass on the guy you ought to be taking there, but still, be position select.
I thought Sauce Gardner would be the first corner, but you go back to 2019, and that version of Derek Stingley is as good as anybody in this entire draft class.
Find out right here on your exclusive home for the NFL Draft. 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
They say health is wealth, and I could not agree more. That's why if you or somebody in your life is living with everyday aches and pains, I want to tell you about Relief Factor. Relief Factor is a daily supplement that helps fight pain naturally. Naturally. Now that's a big deal. Developed by its doctors, Relief Factor's unique formula of ingredients all work together to help support your body's response to inflammation. Instead of masking pain for a couple of hours, Relief Factor actually helps reduce or even eliminate your pain for good. Whether it's neck, back, joint, or muscle pain, if you're looking to feel better, live better, give Relief Factor a try. In 3 weeks, you will know if it's working because you'll feel it. I was sent Relief Factor for me to try. I've been taking it every single day, and I do feel the difference. Go to ReliefFactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800-4-RELIEF. Save on your first order. Don't let pain tell you how to live. Fight back naturally with Relief Factor. These products and statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease or condition.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. QC is the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades, regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, your joint pain keeping you from doing what you love, then you need to call QC Kinetics now. Surgery, steroids, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics using your own body's power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkopf. Dr. Scheinkopf is a pioneer in this field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. He wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. Call now to learn more about some exciting options in this revolutionary approach to get you long-term relief with no downtime. So what are you waiting for? Call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation. 210-571-0318. That's 210-571-0318. Locations in Hollywood Park, Westover Hills, and New Braunfels.
If you're a man and you live in San Antonio or the surrounding areas, you need to pay close attention to what I'm about to say. Are you having issues rising to the occasion? Do you constantly worry about whether or not you can perform? Have you completely stopped having adult time? Is it something you just don't talk about? Guys, we have a solution. Mojo, the 100% guaranteed male enhancement pill that's fast, effective, and was designed to reignite performance and confidence in the bedroom.
Yeah.
Be ready at a moment's notice with the Mojo Male Enhancement Pill from Pure Line Nutrition. And for those of you who have used Mojo, check out Mojo Enduramax.
Touchdown!
A new formula that improves the potency and effectiveness of Mojo. Get fast results, last longer, and be the man she'll never forget. Mojo and Mojo Enduramax, 100% natural male enhancement formulas only available at Pure Line Nutrition. Call now, 210-494-2210. That's 210-494-2210. Or visit us online at thepureline.com.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's A-U-D-A-C-Y.
We have established a championship program. It's just not the world championship yet.
Oh, man.
Thanks for the reminder.
The
Mike.
Champions of Frisco.
Yes.
He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minix. The draft a week from Thursday.
I can't wait. I really can't. It's always a lot of fun.
You
Looking
know,
forward to it.
It really is. And, you know, mock draft season is what it is. And there's a gazillion mock drafts out there. I'm not a fan of mock drafts yet. I read them all.
Sure.
But there are some that I pay attention to more than others. Peter Schrager Yeah, he's plugged in, but he's not known to me as like one of those draft expert guys. But he puts together his mocks based on what he's been hearing.
Uh-huh.
Where others are scouts and this is what they would do and blah, blah, blah. Schrager has one today, says Xavier Worthy. And man, I tell you what, that's getting all kinds of run because nobody would believe the Cowboys would actually do something like that. Except I would.
Well, I mean,
and I could talk myself into it because it's Jerry and there is a need there. If there is a different plan, they need another wide receiver. We hear Steven talking about, well, they can't do much because they've earmarked all this money for CeeDee Dak and Micah Parsons. And until those deals are done, you know, but they've accounted for spending that kind of money. You know, think about your own household. You know, if this is coming up and this bill is due and you need this and that, well, maybe you're not going on vacation. Right. That's kind of what the Cowboys are doing right now. They're planning within their salary cap.
Well, that's what they say.
Well, it's what they say. And all we can do is go on what they tell us. Right.
Uh-huh.
And we can assume whether they're lying to us or not, because it is also lying season. Hard to believe anything that you hear this time of year.
Right. Well, yes, of course. I just can't see this happening. Honestly, I can't. You know, you and I were talking about this before the show and going over the offensive linemen that the Cowboys currently have on the roster. Would this guy work? Do you think this guy's okay? Well, you know, the Cowboys think that, you know, they've kept him around for some reason. There's no way. I just look, if the Cowboys have done something good over the past, say, what, 10, 15 years, it's draft offensive linemen.
Okay.
They need offensive linemen. They need some depth there. Even if you think that what they currently have right now is good to go.
Think about what you just said.
Let's
pause and think of it. They've been really good over the last 10 to 15 years drafting offensive linemen. That is what you just said.
That's what I said.
Right?
Yes.
You don't draft for depth in the first round. So right now, if you were to go with what they currently have, you know, you kick Tyler Smith out the left tackle, you got TJ Bass, Brock Hoffman, Zach Martin, Terrence Steele. You know, we've been hearing about Matt Molesko, who hasn't been able to get healthy yet for a couple of years, it feels like. They're bringing back Chuma Adoga. Seam Richards, you know, rookie last year when he got called upon to play, played well. The one guy that scares the hell out of me is Josh Ball. If I never see Josh Ball again, I'm good. But maybe he's developed to a point where the Cowboys are comfortable with him.
Okay.
You know, and again, I'm not saying I believe this, but based on what the Cowboys have done in the past, they've kept guys around like a Rico Dowdle. Remember last year when, you know, we were all talking about who was going to be the backup and everybody was high on Malik Davis. Uh-huh. And I kept saying, dude, what about Rico Dowdle? They have kept that guy around for a long time.
Sure.
And it ended up being Rico Dowdle. You know, Terrence Steele was a guy that...
Who had a horrible year last year, by the way. Everybody forgets that. Well, he had a bad year last year.
Especially compared to the year before.
Yes. And,
but when you go back to his rookie year, undrafted kid, was not good. And then they kept telling us all offseason, man, he's been our most improved guy. He's like getting a certificate to put on his fridge with all the good work that he's doing. And he was great. And then he got hurt.
Last year he wasn't as good, and he got paid too. Sometimes that's a detriment.
He got paid. So if you were to go with what they are telling us and a little bit of that history, maybe they are feeling like they're okay on the offensive line, that they don't need a first round offensive lineman. Maybe they'll do something in the third round with the offensive line. Remember, Tyler Biadasz was a fourth round pick.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe if you want to talk yourself into Xavier Worthy, you can do that.
Sure. You can talk yourself into anything.
Well, I mean, I'm not saying that I would do it, but if you're sitting in those meeting rooms, are they having these kind of conversations?
I'm sure they are.
How good do they really feel about those guys? Let's bring some memory to your memory. Last year in the draft, and the Cowboys are so good at releasing war room video that comes back to bite them in the ass. Like this little clip from last year, they are literally on the clock. They're talking about two guys and the phone rings.
The 12th and 13th pick are on the board. You got Bergeron and you got Mazi. Mazi
would create a dynamic that we do not have now, and he would take some of the pressure off our outside rushers. I'm ready to take the nose guard. I don't need any more about Mozzie. As far as I'm concerned, with the few minutes we've got right here, let's try to sell the hell out of Bergeron over Smith.
He's strong. He's very technical. I think he's got swing tackle ability.
And if he does what we're all saying he can do, then you got your left tackle, you got your left guard, you got your fairly young center. And
Buffalo came up.
The Jacksonville Jaguars have traded the 25th.
Are not any different in their grade relative to quality of football.
Well, who would you take?
Personally, I would go with Mozzie. I love Bergeron, but I think Mozzie helps us now and in the future.
The nose guy is a hell of a strategic pick for us, for our defense now.
Absolutely. Our run defense is better. Clearly, we pick him. He makes that impact, without a doubt.
Who do we line up at nose guard?
Cowboys, you offered what number?
Which do we drop off the most if we don't get...
Let us talk about that real quick.
That's Steven.
Okay, thanks.
Which one?
Like a fourth.
Are we on there?
No, but we're on the clock. Question is, do you want to go back five spots for the third?
If we lose these two players and get that three, how sick are we compared to if we don't give up? We just give up the three and take one of these players. I, without trying to influence anybody here, I'm sick of if we miss both those guys at the top. And we've been sitting here. I'm sick. I mean, there's a certain amount of risk reward here. I am cutthroat if we missed one of those two guys after having them both here in our hands.
And for our run defense, is a must. I mean, that's where we started this whole conversation postseason. We're just getting warmed up.
I like it, Mike. I like it.
Mike McCarthy wanted Mozzie Smith. I mean, he was pushing hard for that guy.
Mm-hmm.
And Jerry wanted him too, but I think McCarthy was the tipped them over the edge there to skip out. Now, all they had to do was move back five spots, and they would have picked up a third-round pick
from
the Kansas City Chiefs.
But they wanted Mozzie Smith. Bergeron went in the second round to Atlanta, pick 38.
Uh-huh.
So they could have gone back five spots.
And gotten one of the – maybe Mozzie.
Maybe Bergeron. We have no idea what Kansas City wanted to move up for, right? We have no idea – what Kansas City ultimately wanted to do. And you could look at whether it was Mozzie Smith or the picks that followed, was there somebody there that Kansas City was trying to go get? Who knows?
Obviously there was.
Right. But who knows? Right. But the Cowboys wanted Mozzie Smith and they thought he was going to make an immediate impact.
You heard McCarthy.
And with your first round pick, you need immediate impact. They did not get that this year. Stephen Jones today, on 105.3, the Fan up in Dallas, says he still feels really good about Mozzie Smith.
First of all, he didn't play as much as we would have liked, and I think it was a learning process with him, learning what Dan wanted out of the defensive lineman. We knew when we drafted him out of Michigan, he was asked to play the one technique a little different than Dan likes to see it played. I think the way Zim's going to ask these guys to play is probably a little more in line with what he did at Michigan. But we feel really good about Mozzie. We happen to have some good veteran players, but that's one of the great things that happens when young guys get a chance to step up. Obviously, Tolbert had a slow year his rookie year, but then stepped up and played really well, and we expect him to continue to grow as a receiver. It's not often that young guys get to step in and play right away. It doesn't always happen that way, especially on playoff teams, but we feel really good about Mozzie.
Well, it was all Dan Quinn's fault, apparently. I mean, he just didn't use Mozzie right. It was all his fault. Zimmer will come in and fix everything because, he's more of the Michigan style defense, and that's where Mozzie will look. I expect Mozzie to play better, and
he can't play worse.
Well, true transparency, when that pick happened, we were excited about it.
Sure,
I certainly was, and I thought, well, that's what they need. They drafted for a need there, and hopefully for them, Mozzie will step up and play better this year. He has to. Hankins is gone.
Well,
right. I mean, so it's Mozzie's job.
And again, you want your first-round pick, and for that matter, your second-round pick, to have immediate impact as rookies.
Sure.
That didn't happen last year, but that doesn't mean that that draft class is a total bust. It's a bust in year one, but if those guys do develop and become the kind of players the Cowboys are hoping they become, then you could look back at that draft and say, well, it took a while, but it worked out pretty good. Mm-hmm. That's why it's always tough to grade a draft with a grade written in Sharpie, you know, after year one or the day after the draft. The day after the draft, I think the Cowboys got pretty good grades, right? And then you look back at it at the end of the season, well, we all missed on that because nobody was complaining about the guys that they took. Mozzie Smith was a great pick last year. We had him on the air the day after, and whoever the Cowboys take a week from Thursday will be on the Blitz a week from Friday. And who knows who we're going to be talking to. But the reality is, we all thought that was a good pick, and first year wasn't there. Why? You know, Steven can tell us technique, all these different things. Was it Dan Quinn? Who knows? I mean, when we saw Mozzie out at training camp, I mean, there were some plays where he looked like, man, that guy's going to be a beast. And then other plays where he looked lost. And then other times he was just looking for people to send him nudes.
That was it.
Joe sent him a toe pic.
That's really the only thing I can remember about Mozzie Smith. I mean, look.
His underwear?
You
sick.
Well, I'm just saying. I mean, it was kind of right there in front of you, and it's big.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's a billboard, pal, on the back of those drawers. Look, anybody can look good in training camp. And I know that's important and you get it, but, you know, looking good in training camp and then translating that into Sunday afternoon are two different things. Mozzie couldn't do that. Now, another step, time in, all of that kind of stuff could make a difference. Schoonmaker wasn't, I mean, because of what they got out of Jake Ferguson, Schoonmaker really wasn't, you know, you could hide him. That wasn't that big of a deal. But to draft that guy second, I think was a panic move by the Cowboys, for sure. And so, and then Deuce Vaughn, I mean, when they drafted him, it was great. I cried. But then after that, it was like, boy, what a waste that was.
Well, and again, I mean, you look at last year's draft and this incredibly non-busy free agency period, which has everybody questioning what the hell are they doing. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that I would say at that is, I mean, they must have a lot of belief in some of these young players. They're going to tell you they're cash strapped. They could create money if they wanted to. But Stephen Jones was asked, you know, a lot of fans right now not believing in you guys. How do you respond?
Well, at the end of the day, you always can only, and we spend max money, you know, year in and year out. All 32 can only spend the same amount of money over a 5-year stretch. And when we're all said and done, we max out our salary cap every year, and we will have done that. And, you know, what comes with having a good roster, which we do, and, you know, we also, you know, are looking towards signing our own guys. It doesn't mean it happens overnight, but when you're wanting to sign players like Dak and Micah and CD, then, you know, that certainly you have to hold money back if you want to have a realistic chance at signing those guys.
Well, sure. That's exactly what you have to do.
Mm-hmm.
I did at the end of the season, I think for about a week after, we heard about a Trayvon Diggs restructure.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't seen it. I mean, there's some money there to be gotten. I mean, he's right. Look, you can find money. If there's a free agent out there, you can find the money to pay those guys.
I just kind of look at, especially on the defensive side, with all the guys that have left the organization, there's not, I don't know, maybe one that you go, oh, that one hurt. I mean, I just feel like the Cowboys could have kept every one of those guys if they wanted to. If they wanted to. I don't know that anybody got away where the Cowboys felt like, man, I can't believe that happened, including Tyron Smith, right? I mean, including Tyron Smith.
Well, I think all of us felt it was the end there. The Jets are hoping that we were all wrong about Tyron Smith and that he's got some left in the tank.
And it's emotional with a guy like Tyron Smith because he's a future Hall of Famer. Then you would love to see him start and finish his career with Dallas. But for the last couple of years, how many of our fans, Cowboy fans, have called this show or tweeted or whatever, man, they got to let him go. Jerry gets so much criticism for keeping a guy for a year or two too long. And then he lets one go, maybe a year too late. And everybody's like, well, what the hell are you doing? What are we going to do at left tackle? I mean, that was a good move for the Cowboys not to bring him back. But then you saw the contract, and he went, yeah, Cowboys should have been able to do that.
And there were a couple of those guys. You know, I go back to the Derrick Henry thing. You know, you get Derrick Henry for $9 million for 2 years. I mean, don't you have to find a way to get that done? That solves that problem right there. I mean, so you don't even have to worry about that in the draft. There are a lot of things that went by. And then you go and you say, well, maybe these unproven linemen, maybe they feel pretty good about that. Well, nobody knows. Nobody knows. And you're hoping that they are. You hope you see them playing well in practice. You see them doing these things. And then, well, you're hoping it translates into Sunday afternoon. And I guess we'll see, because if they pick Xavier Worthy number one with the 24th pick, then they must feel pretty good about what they've got in the offensive line, because there's a couple of pretty good offensive linemen, including a center and a left tackle
that you could have for a decade.
Exactly.
They project to be 10-year starters on your offensive line.
Yes. So we'll see.
I still want an offensive lineman.
Yes. And I think that's where they should go. And I'm thinking, well, I mean, left tackle. Look, Smith told us he doesn't want to play left tackle. He said he'll do it, but he doesn't want to. So why wouldn't you replace that and let him play guard where he's more comfortable?
I don't know. If I'm Mozzie Smith, I know what he said on
the
podcast.
Not Mozzie, Tyler Smith.
Or Tyler Smith. Yeah, well, one of the Smith guys. the left tackle one, the left guard one, Tyler. Tyler Smith. I know that's what he said on the podcast.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if that's what he really believes. Because if I'm his agent, Tyler, play tackle. Left tackles make a lot more money than left guards, and your contract is coming up. Let's kick you out the tackle because you get paid better.
Well, we'll see.
You might like guard, but you like money more. Well, left tackles get paid, and then get paid and then ask to move back inside.
Sure. Well, by then, Zach Martin will be gone, right? Retired. So he can slide in there.
The right guard?
Sure.
On the left side.
Just saying.
I mean, it'd screw up your footwork.
Well, hey.
It's all there.
Martin's made a lot of money.
He has.
Yeah.
He has. It is the Blitz here on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star. You know, Mike Tyson has made a lot of money.
He has.
Also smokes a lot of weed, but he is giving up weed for a good reason, to make more money. We'll explain coming up here on the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. You know, nobody ever plans on getting arrested, but it does happen to a lot of people every day for all kinds of reasons. Fiesta starting this week. You know, nobody's planning on getting arrested, but it's Fiesta. You know, it's going to happen. So write the number down, 210-225-2121. Because if you get arrested, you want to get out of jail fast. Best way to do that is by calling my good friend Albert and his great staff at AA Best Bail Bonds. Again, 210-225-2121. You can text the word bail to 474747 or even start the bonding process online at mybestbailbonds.com. You don't have to call attorneys or anybody else to get out of jail, and you don't want to be forced into a PR bond. If the jail offers you a PR bond, make sure you truly understand what those conditions are before accepting it. Your best option for stress-free bail bonds is AA Best Bail Bonds because nobody beats their price. They offer payment plans, a free shuttle service. They are discreet and confidential and open 24/7 with offices all over San Antonio and Texas, services nationwide. So if you're up in Dallas, down in Corpus, over at Taste of the North Side, license number 149, call AA Best Bail Bonds, 210-225-2121, or go online at mybestbailbonds.com.
You're riding with a Blitz. Afternoons 2 to 6, KTFM Floresville, and everywhere at sasportstar.com.
Jason Minnix here from the Blitz. With the NBA playoffs here, you want to get in on the action and have fun watching the games the way I do? Make sure you download the Underdog Fantasy app and start playing their pick'em game, where you pick between 2 and 5 players to build a pick'em entry, select higher or lower on player stats. If your picks hit, you could win up to 100 times your money, endless projections to choose from. You create your own experience. It's a ton of fun to play. I love winning on the pick'em game, obviously. It is fantasy, but legal in Texas. So get signed up at underdogfantasy.com or download the Underdog Fantasy app. Use my promo code STAR when you sign up, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. Must be over 18 and present in a state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org. Again, promo code STAR when you sign up at underdogfantasy.com.
Thanks for calling Discover. This is Gabby.
Hey, Gabby. It's Jennifer Coolidge. Hi. I'm so glad I reached you at 2 a.m.
Oh, of course. Anyone with a Discover card can call and talk to a real person 24/7. Now, how can I help?
Yeah, I used my Discover card to buy these yellow pleather pajamas, and I'm just not sure I'm pulling them off.
24/7 U.S.-based customer service. It pays to Discover. Limitations apply. Learn more at discover.com/creditcard.
Free! Who doesn't love free? With Milo's Rewards, you get the member-only treatment that's actually worth it. Enjoy free member gifts you'll love. And once you reach Silver Key status, you can get free standard shipping. Because Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Learn more about our new loyalty program at lowes.com/Milo's Rewards today. Program subject to terms and conditions. See lowes.com/terms for details. Member gifts may be subject to additional terms and restrictions. See lowes.com/shipping terms for details. Subject to change.
Do you have unfiled tax returns or being threatened by the IRS that your wages are about to be garnished or bank accounts are going to be levied? You need an ally. Allies Tax Relief has professionals ready to fight for you. Their enrolled agents, tax attorneys, and CPAs have saved millions of dollars for taxpayers just like you. They won't just resolve your tax problems. They'll most importantly protect your wages, bank accounts, and all your assets from being taken by the IRS. Call for a free consultation. 800-230-5174. 800-230-5174. Or go to allies-taxrelief.com.
Nigel, what's up with your hair?
Joe, prices are insane these days. I'm cutting my own hair.
Folks, nobody likes paying high prices. Good news, for a limited time, all Quarter Moon 14-SEER AC systems up to 3 tons are installed in your house for only $69.99. Now is the ideal time to take care of your home at the lowest price of the year.
Joe, I like saving money. I'm an influencer. Everywhere I go, people hand me change and say, bless your heart.
Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC. 210-651-5899. License number N16004, DACLA 000-743-45.
Not to brag, but Progressive's Name Your Price tool is mankind's greatest tool ever. Even better than the wheel. Sure, without the wheel, we wouldn't have modern transportation or funny videos of dogs riding skateboards. But without the Name Your Price tool, we wouldn't have easy access to auto insurance options based on our budget. And, well, cars do need wheels. They also need insurance, and insurance never goes flat. Learn more about the greatest tool ever, the Name Your Price tool, at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law. Not available in all states.
Whether you own a local business or a global one, you're always looking for ways to position your operation to create opportunities and move on them faster. With Bank of America, you get access to experts, award-winning insights, and business solutions so powerful, you'll make every move matter, locally and globally. Visit bankofamerica.com/bankingforbusiness to learn more. What would you like the power to do? Copyright 2024 Bank of America N.A.
Cowboys play here. 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. San Antonio's Sports Center.
Got a final from Big League Baseball this afternoon. The Texas Rangers fall short against the Detroit Tigers, losing that game by a score of 4-2. Houston Astros continue their series with the Braves today. Astros also called up former first-round pick and Alamo Heights pitcher Forrest Whitley, who will be available out of the bullpen. First pitch there is set for 7:10 tonight at Minute Maid Park, and the Missions are in Corpus Christi.
SportsCenter is brought to you by Byers Barricades, the Texas authority in barricade rental. ByersBarricades.com.
Joe Reinagle.
That's the third time in 7 seasons the San Antonio Spurs are the NBA champions.
Jason Minnix.
They go back to big day as Super Bowl champions. Dallas 52, Buffalo 17.
It's the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1, a San Antonio Sports Star. He is Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minnix. Glad to have you along on this Tuesday afternoon.
Kind of a yucky Tuesday afternoon. Huh?
Yucky.
Yucky.
Is that official weather term?
It's been yucky all day.
Was it supposed to be yucky today?
Dude, I don't know. You want me to call Bill Taylor?
No, I'm asking Bill Taylor.
No, I'm the fake Bill Taylor. Only when it you know, if they get in line first or something, you know, I'll pretend to be Bill Taylor.
So looking at the forecast, I didn't realize it was supposed to be yucky today. When I had to take the trash out this morning, I thought, well, this sucks. And even when I went to lunch, well, I met you for lunch.
You did.
Just driving over not far from the station, I was like, well, this is kind of a crappy day.
Yucky.
But the rest of the week looks perfect. Thursday is what I'm eyeing. Low of 72, a high of 91 as the Blitz gets ready to broadcast live at a Taste of the North Side.
91 for the high. Huh?
Yeah, baby.
Wow, perfect.
The weekend doesn't look good. There's rain on Saturday.
Really?
Yeah, but I'll be in Dustin, Florida, so I don't give a damn.
Well, what's the weather look like there?
Perfect.
Are you sure?
I haven't checked. It's white sandy beaches in Florida. It should be perfect. It'll probably rain at some point in the afternoon. That's a Florida thing, right?
Yeah. Certainly a Miami thing.
Yeah.
You can set your watch by that about 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Storm rolls through.
Dustin, Florida. I don't know if it rains there.
I don't know.
I've never been to Dustin, but I'm told it's perfect and the best beaches in Florida.
Nice. Now, your app said 91 on Thursday.
Yes.
Yeah, mine says 89.
Well,
I prefer that.
89 as opposed to 91.
I do.
Would you notice a difference?
Sure.
No, you wouldn't.
It's 2 degrees.
You would not. You would not notice a two-degree difference.
2 whole degrees.
You would not notice 2 degrees.
But we'll see who's right. That's like a mock weather report.
Well, what weather app are you using?
It's the Fox Weather app.
Okay.
That I use. Yeah. It says 89 and partly cloudy. A low of 72.
So what do I make of you 25 years at Ken's TV not using the Bill Taylor weather app and using the one from Fox?
Well, I've got this one over here.
Just saying.
Don't tell Bill.
My Apple phone, it says 91 right now for Thursday. We're going to be live at Taste of the North Side at the Security Service Federal Credit Union Event Center, a Fiesta event for foodies. All proceeds benefit the Brighton Center. Get your tickets and join the Blitz live Thursday at Taste of the North Side. Go to brightonsa.org, tasteofthenorthside.org to get your tickets. Promo code STAR will save you $25 a ticket. Every ticket is VIP.
And look, it's like an all-inclusive resort. You know, you pay the money for the ticket, and you don't have to reach for a dollar unless you want to tip somebody. That's up to you.
Tip.
Sure.
Yeah.
But you don't have to pay for anything.
No. All your food.
The food, drink, everything.
Yeah.
And it's
high end.
It's the good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
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 It's not corny dogs and turkey legs. Oh, they might have a turkey leg.
Or corn dog. Elevate it. Corn dog.
Well, how do you elevate a corn dog?
You serve it a Taste of the North Side.
Is that how you do it?
Yeah, exactly.
Now see, I like what they did with the Frito pie. You have Wagyu chili in there.
See, there you go.
That's what I'm talking about. I don't know if you can upgrade a corn dog.
I think you can.
I don't know.
Just your description alone.
Maybe. An upgraded corn dog pledge? What is it then?
Well, it's a high-end pig.
Exactly. What is this, a royal pig?
Use that, and there's high-end, like, breading. You're not using your
You're using Dijon mustard instead of regular yellow mustard? Yeah. That makes it high-end.
In other words, there is not one.
No, there is.
And they hooked Pledge on this Food Network. There's no high-end corn dog.
Well, there could be.
No.
I mean, you could really have that.
And maybe they could get their dogs from Tri-County.
I mean, that would make them high-end.
That would
upgrade. Hot dog on a stick,
yeah,
you know, with a nice wrapping. You come up with some fancy chef terms, that, you know.
Wasn't that a sausage wrap?
Well sometimes, Joe. The corn dog is battered in what?
Cornmeal.
Okay, so you could take this elevated pork roll.
Uh-huh.
With a cornmeal blanket around it
on
a stick. Now it sounds elevated, served with Dijon mustard.
And then it tastes just like a regular old corn dog.
It'd be high end at that point. It could be. I mean, let yourself go and have some fun here.
There's not going to be corn dogs in Taste of the North Side.
Somebody going out there, please bring a corn dog.
I'm going to kind of bet that there won't be corn dogs at Taste of the North Side.
Maybe they'll have corn dog bites.
They might have that.
You could take a corn dog and take it off the stick, slice it up, and serve it, you know, sushi style.
Sushi style. So you're not going to cook it?
Well, no. I mean, it would be cooked, but the way you slice it up and serve them like the little rolls, you know, it's kind of like over at Topgolf. They have that, what the hell do they call it? Like a mushy. It's like a burrito, but they slice it up like it's sushi, right?
Oh.
Yeah. Do that. Let's do the headline.
Never had that.
You know, talking about corn dogs.
This is Jason and Joe's headline blitz. 420. Two guys, two opinions, never enough time.
As we are approaching 420.
We are.
Weed is still illegal in the state of Texas.
It is.
But corn dogs, I'm told, is quite the munchy food when you're
I'm sure it high. Is. And Jack in the Box tacos.
Everything on the Jack in the Box late night menu is meant for people that aren't sober.
Yes.
I don't know if you guys are aware, but Mike Tyson smokes a lot of weed.
Uh-huh.
He's got his own weed line. He smokes on every one of his podcast episodes, Hot Boxing with Mike Tyson. For the record, according to USA Today, there's been about 275 or so episodes of his podcast, and he smokes weed in every one of them.
Sure.
And again, he has a weed line, so he calls that work, quality control.
Of course.
But as he's getting ready for the fight with Jake Paul in Dallas, he is giving up marijuana so he can have this fight. He is a rule follower.
Nice.
Because weed is on the banned substance list for boxing in the state of Texas.
Well, he has plenty of incentive to give up weed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about money.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Not good for him.
Marijuana is on the list of banned substances by the Texas Department of Licensing and Regulation, which regulates combat sports in Texas. A failed drug test results in an automatic 90-day suspension, a fine, and if the winner of the fight tests positive, the outcome is changed to no decision. So even if he, you know, provides a urine sample and then says, all right, well, I've peed in the cup, I'm going to go get high, they test as soon as the fight is over. And, you know, so he won't be able to smoke until after he pees in the cup after the fight, and he's on his private jet back to Vegas.
You think he's got a private jet?
It's Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson?
Yes.
Well, I know. The guy went broke once, got it back. And
Dude, the guy is pissed away $100 million a couple different times.
Sure.
I mean, I know Mike Tyson has done that. My buddy Lee Steinberg, he's another one that has gone broke, lost $100 million, made it back, lost it again, made it back. You know, people that can do that can do that.
That's incredible.
Tyson also used
to add $100 million to blow.
Tyson also said he used mushrooms before fights, but that too is also illegal in Texas. So yeah, he's going to be clean and sober for this fight.
Well, good for him. It didn't help Tiger Woods much, but.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, I guess it wasn't the same thing. Well, Woods gave up sex.
What's harder, giving up sex or giving up weed? I mean, for Mike Tyson to give up weed, if you're addicted to anything, I mean, and all of us have our different addictions.
Sure.
You know, some are destructive, some aren't. They're just, you know, but an addiction is an addiction.
It is.
Right? Regardless of what it is. When you have to give that up, it can mess with you.
It's tough.
What are you showing me here, Pledge? That's all Tyson's going to make on this?
That's what he's worth, I think. Yeah. He's only worth $10 million.
Well, no wonder he needs to fight.
But sure. Or he's 58 years old.
He's got to be worth more than that. He's probably divested a lot, put things in a trust.
Hey, yeah. Well, he's probably making a lot of money with the pot.
Well, wasn't he making like $1 million a month with the pot? Now, granted, that doesn't necessarily mean it's profit.
Well, it doesn't. And, you know, in the famous words of Scarface, never get high on your own supply. Okay? I mean, shouldn't do that.
Smoke away the profit.
Exactly. Be stealing my lucky charms.
Probably not do voices either, but, you know, whatever.
I don't know. They're getting better.
Are they?
Yes.
College football is about to get worse.
Dude.
Well, not worse, but chaos is coming because the 15-day transfer portal window begins. Chaos is ready to ready to roll in college football once again.
Well, apparently the Texas A&M Aggies have had some issues. They had another guy enter the portal today. Jacoby Matthews, a safety, has entered the portal. They've had about 9 or 10 guys do that since Mike Elko got there. So, and he probably doesn't mind that. It's probably guys that, I didn't say he doesn't want, but guys that, you know, he knows he can replace and wants his own guys in there. And that happens, right, with a new head coach.
Yep, yep. Although, interesting that it happens after spring, and I think guys know where they are after the spring game, and you realize, well, it ain't here.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna hit the window, and I'm gonna be gone. It's gonna be interesting to see what happens. It is the Blitz here on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star. New San Antonio Brahmas quarterback Quentin Normandy is gonna join us at 4:35. He takes over for the injured Chase Garbers, who's out for the season with a wrist injury. So we'll talk to the former Bernie Greyhound coming up at 4:35 here on the Blitz. Did you guys watch the Masters? Serious question. Masters ratings were way down this year. Why? And I guess I'm not asking if you watched. If you chose not to watch the Masters,
why?
Why? 210-656-ESPN, 656-3776.
You know, when I look on social media, it always makes me smile when I see all these success stories from Parkhurst New Vision, and I see a lot of them. And it's kind of cool because you feel like you're part of the community of Parkhurst New Vision success stories. I certainly am. Had lens replacement surgery, and it's been about a year now, and my eyesight is fantastic. Don't need readers, don't need glasses, don't need any of that stuff. And you read the reviews and the good stories on social media, you see all those other folks have gotten rid of the readers and the glasses, all of it. You can do the same thing. Dr. Parkhurst and his great staff over there are going to take very good care of you. In fact, the whole place is fantastic. You feel like your family the moment you walk in there. Parkhurst New Vision. You got to give them a call. That's the first step. 210-585-2020. You can also check them out online at sanantoniolasic.com. When you call Parkhurst New Vision, you set up a consultation, your initial consultation. You go in there. If you've got questions, ask them. They will explain to you exactly how the process is going to go. But do me a favor. Tell them Joe Reinagel from the Blitz sent you over there. That would mean a lot to me, and I would appreciate it. So do that, and then your life is going to be changed. Join us. The community of Parkhurst New Vision success stories. Give them a call today. 210-585-2020.
It's the 2024 NFL Draft on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
We're the 24th pick. The Dallas Cowboys select.
April 25th, 26th, and 27th. Join 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star for this year's NFL Draft. Live from Detroit.
I love the tenacity and the aggression with which he plays. He is a mauler.
Who do the Cowboys and Texans pick? Does Jerry make a splash? Who goes number one? And who's the next Mr. Irrelevant?
The Houston Texans select C.J. Stroud.
We don't ever want to pass on the guy you ought to be taking there, but still, be position select.
I thought Sauce Gardner would be the first corner, but you go back to 2019, and that version of Derek Stingley is as good as anybody in this entire draft class.
Find out right here on your exclusive home for the NFL Draft. 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Hi, I'm attorney Steve Benke. If you've made the decision to divorce, you need an experienced attorney who can help. I've helped many people get through divorce, custody, child support, and alimony problems. Call me. I'm attorney Steve Benke.
210-DIVORCE or go to BenkeLaw.com.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts, so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The good folks at Wendy's have a revolutionary new product for you. Introducing the new Orange Dreamsicle Frosty. It's like a time machine that takes you all the way back to now, the year 2024.
It's the classic, creamy, orangey flavor you remember. Dare I say, it's new timey. It's the flavor you grew up with, just all grown up. Head over to your local Wendy's establishment and get yours while supplies last. The new Orange Dreamsicle Frosty. Here for the now, for now.
Limited time only at participating Wendy's.
Our daughter Jessie loves playing detective.
A clue.
But since we discovered she has sensitive skin, we've been playing detective too.
We thought the problem was our puppy.
But it was actually our old detergent.
Aha. Uh-huh.
So we switched to Tide Free and Gentle. Tide cleans better than the leading competitive free detergent, and it doesn't leave behind irritating residues.
Plus, Tide Free and Gentle has no dyes or perfumes, so it's gentle on her skin.
Case closed.
If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide Free and Gentle.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. 120,000 miles of night drives, daily commutes, and who knows how many.
Are we there yet?
Through countless fixes, elbow grease, and a new radiator, you kept your ride alive. With eBay Motors, you have over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Are you a victim of the timeshare trap and think there's no way out? I'm Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group, the original timeshare cancellation expert. And I'm here to tell you that there is a way out. All you need to do is give my office a call. I will send you a timeshare exit information kit absolutely free, explaining how the timeshare industry works and your options for cancellation.
Call Wesley now for your free info kit. 800-881-4242. That's 800-881-4242.
Jim Rome, join me weekdays at noon on my new home, 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minnick. I love the Masters. But quite honestly, this year, the Masters I watched in the morning on Sunday, Tiger, who was not playing well. And then I left and I went to the Brahmas game.
Mm-hmm.
I was at the Brahmas game watching the Masters on my phone, following along. But I had something else that I wanted to go do.
Sure.
And there wasn't a lot of drama either. I didn't ever feel like I'm missing out, although I was paying attention to the golf on my phone while sitting in the Alamo Dome. I know you were watching the Masters at a Masters party.
I was.
So I was a little surprised today to read an article with the headline, ratings for final round of the 2024 Masters take a beating. Like, wow. All right. How bad was it? Wow. They were down quite a bit.
That's usually what beating means.
Well, I mean, John Rahm had an easy 4-stroke lead. There was no drama last year.
Yeah.
Scottie Scheffler the year before, the drama there. We didn't have one of those Masters finishes where, you know, because of Twitter, everybody's like, oh, man, I got to get to my TV like we had a couple of weeks ago at the end of the Valero Texas Open.
Right.
We didn't have that, but we haven't had that for a couple of years. So why is this year's Masters down significantly from last year when basically you had a very similar type of finish?
Well, last year's Sunday at the Masters was on Easter Sunday.
Okay.
Okay. I think obviously a holiday gives you a boost. Anytime.
It's a TV right. term. Holiday boost and
holiday
ratings.
Boost, yes. Right? So that's
why
does.
Every sports league wants to play on a holiday.
Number two, you know, I just think with what has happened in golf, people are kind of tuned out by it. You know, with some of the players leaving for the LIV Tour, and then you've got a bunch of up-and-comers on the PGA Tour now that are coming from these minor league tours, for lack of a better word, like the Korn Ferry Tour and that. People don't know who they are. And there's really not that one guy. Now, Scheffler's a great player, but there's no pizzazz to Scottie Scheffler.
He doesn't
right?
move the needle?
No.
He's not Tiger.
Hell of a golfer, don't get me wrong. But even if you were to have a, I think a Rory McIlroy would be a bigger draw. We've seen Jordan Spieth be a bigger draw. You need somebody like that in contention, I think, to move the needle. I love watching Scottie Scheffler play. The guy's a machine. But there's just something about him that just doesn't quite get it or give it out to the fans that are watching.
If you're at home Sunday and you didn't watch the Masters, why? 210-656-ESPN, 656-3776. You could tweet at Joe Reinagle 210, tweet at me at Jason Mennix. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to the San Antonio Sports Star YouTube channel, and you can comment there. Because I am curious if there is the lack of Tiger effect that is in play for the casual golf fan, that it would be more like me. I love the majors. I love the Masters. But on a random Sunday, I'm not going to say make appointment television to watch the final round of the Wells Fargo tournament that's coming up in a couple of weeks in North Carolina. Or, you know, just now, if I'm at home and I see on Twitter that there is some incredible stuff happening, I will go watch it. But I'm probably not going to just stumble upon it and leave it there and watch it. I'm not that kind of a golf fan. So, but a major is different. I'm there for all of it. So I'm you will watch all of them. So we're two different people, but like I went to the Brahmas game. You wouldn't have gone to the Brahmas game because the Masters was on.
No, right? And I'm going to watch it, and that's what I do.
So I'm just curious, are people finding like Jay on the YouTube says, I just find golf boring.
A lot of people do,
Fred Casera says, if Tiger Woods is in play, I'm watching.
Now, why is that? And Tiger had his effect. I mean, obviously, but Tiger was just different. When you look at Scottie Scheffler, and I will say he's obviously not up to the standard of Tiger Woods. I'm not saying that, but as it sits right now, he is the Tiger Woods of the PGA Tour, just on that level. Look, when he's in a tournament, you got to figure he's got to be the favorite to win it. And that's the way he's playing right now, just like Tiger was. Every time he went into a tournament and Tiger was there, you figured he's going to win it, or at least he's going to be at the top of the leaderboard.
So the question I had on Monday, because I'm a Scottie Scheffler guy, and apparently I'm in the minority here, because based on a lot of this stuff that I've been reading, Scottie Scheffler could be at HEB and you wouldn't know it was Scottie Scheffler. So if that's the case, does the PGA need to do more to get him more national commercials? He doesn't move the needle like a Tiger Woods, although with his golf game, I would think that it would. He's not Jordan Spieth. And Jordan Spieth, you know, 4, 5, 6 years ago, you thought he was going to be that guy. Mm-hmm. And his game just hasn't carried him. Rory can't win the Masters for whatever reason. Scottie Scheffler's game is that, but is his personality, is his want to be famous, to do all the commercials?
He doesn't have that personality. I mean, just from the things that he says, he did an interview. I think it was after Saturday's round. It's like, you know, they asked him about how special would it be to win this. And yeah, it's special. It's my job. But, you know, I'm going to go home on Monday, whether I win or lose. I got my wife there. I got my friends there. They never give a damn about, you know, how I did on a tournament. He's just got a different personality. And look, it's like, you know, heavyweight boxing went through the same thing when Mike Tyson and Evander Holyfield, man, it was popular as hell. When those guys left, it kind of fell off the face of the earth. You need those personalities. And I think what has happened with the LIV Tour, and I'm not here to rag on that, even though everybody knows how I feel about it. But I mean, you lose all of the competition. They're going to have to figure out a way to merge this thing and get it back, where all these players are together. And when you watch a golf tournament, if you're into that, you don't know who's going to win. And that's the beauty of it. When Tiger was in, Tiger had an effect on everybody. So it's so much different. But I want to go into a golf tournament thing, well, there's 10, 15 guys that could win this thing. And that's when I find it exciting, when you don't know who's going to win it. And the competition is going to be great. And there's going to be three guys, you know, on the last day the last four holes that are vying to win this thing.
You know, and you look at it, and some of the comments, you know, golf is an appointment, anything unless you're playing in it. Yeah, I mean, if you got a tee time at the Golf Club of Texas, you're going and you're going to have a great time. But watching on television, what do you do? I look at the attendance numbers at the Valero Texas Open. I don't really know what they are, but man,
there were a lot of people out there.
I was out there Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, yes, and it was packed. And haven't seen, because this year's field was so great. Man, on Saturday at the Valero Texas Open, it's been a while since it's been that packed.
Absolutely.
And moving around and getting places. Hey, Joshua, you're on the Blitz, man. Why didn't you watch golf on Sunday?
It's boring, plain and simple. I mean, you even said it there, Jason, without even saying it. Like, you left to go watch a football game where it's not even NFL players. I mean, it's hopeful NFL players.
Well, let me ask you a question, Joshua. I've got to ask you a question. What was it about Tiger that made it exciting to watch?
It wasn't even Tiger. It was, I'm going to tune in to watch the clips. Now the clips are going to be on the phone. It's going to be on Reels. It's going to be on Twitter, whatever you want to watch. I mean, the best part, before I even knew the winner of the Masters, I knew about Tiger shaking hands with the tree. So,
yeah,
like that's just kind of where golf is.
I got some social media has changed the consumer. And again, to your point, Joshua, I went to a live sporting event.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the Brahmas game, but I was following the golf on my phone. I was, because you can watch on your phone,
sure,
but you can also keep up and the highlights and everything that are there. It is interesting when you look at it. And I think one of the great storylines, because before I left for the Brahmas game, I left late, and I'll blame Tiger Woods. We were going to go early and tailgate, but I wasn't leaving Tiger Woods. I was watching his group play on ESPN Plus. As bad as it was, I could not take my eyes off of watching Tiger.
But that's the question. Why? What is it about Tiger that you can't take your eyes off of him?
He's Tiger.
I get that, but that's not an answer.
Well, it is. I'm waiting to see Tiger do Tiger things.
Well, he's not doing those things.
If Manu suited up right now, I'd expect Manu to give me a wow moment. And unfortunately, like, Tiger gives me a wow moment in a bad way. It's like, wow, I can't believe I just saw that from Tiger. But you still want to watch the train wreck. And then he's paired up with the low amateur,
uh-huh,
that Neil Shipley guy who was having the day of his life. He was on Pat McAfee earlier today talking about what it was like to play around with Tiger at the Masters.
Oh, yeah. That was a freaking coolest day of my life. That was can't beat that. I mean, Tiger was so cool. And that's probably once in a lifetime for me. I mean, you know, he doesn't play very much anymore. And who knows when I'll be back in a situation to be playing with him. So, I mean, gosh, it was unbelievable. And I really took it down on like 12 tee. He got a standing ovation, and walking up 18, I let him go up ahead of me. And I mean, that was unbelievable to see that just in person and be inside the ropes. That was so cool.
Were you nervous because of the patrons, because you're at the Masters of Golf playing with Tiger? Or like when you hit that one short one, cheeky, mm-hmm, little side, mm-hmm, spin, are you pumped? Like, all right, I just showed Tiger that at least I'm a guy. You know, like, was there any of that? Was there any of those moments that were happening? And when you hit those, is it different than your normal tournament, or were you locked in?
I mean, I was pretty locked in. At the end of the day, it's just golf. But I mean, the coolest thing was, I think I like really roped a drive on two, and Tiger was like, "Hey, good drive." And I was just like, "Oh my gosh, like that was freaking sick."
That's awesome.
Oh, it is awesome. And that's, you know, Max Homa, I told you about he played with Tiger on Saturday. And said there were times when he would look across the fairway at Tiger and say, I was just a fan then. I almost forgot I was playing. I'm watching Tiger Woods. And that's the effect that Tiger had. Look, every sport has their generational talent. It come along every now and then, right? Tiger was at for golf. And can golf recover from that? It's going to be interesting to see.
Going to be very interesting to see. Surprising to see the Masters ratings down as much as they are.
Golf ratings are down, period, and it's because of the split. It's just that simple.
You're just going to blame the lip types.
No, I'm not.
It's
fault. It's because of the split.
Yeah.
That's exactly why it is. That's not my opinion. That's a fact.
Well, and again, I do agree with the idea that you don't have Phil, you don't have some of the big names, and there's a report out today, although Rory is dismissing it, that Liv has offered him $850 million.
Well, his agent is denying that, and I'm quite sure his agent probably said, take it.
Take it.
Go ahead, Roy. You don't need that PGA Tour. I need 20% of that $800 million.
I'll take three.
I'm just saying. So his agent's the ones that's denying it. I couldn't see Rory. I mean, it's like Tiger. They offered him $1 billion, and he said no.
Yeah, if you're Rory, like, dude, you offered Tiger $1 billion, and yeah. I'm a better golfer today than he is.
Well, you're not Tiger, though.
Yeah, the Tiger effect.
I like
you just
Rory.
Answered your own yeah. question.
Too. I like Rory.
Yeah.
But he's not Tiger.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star, a little more than a week away from the NFL draft. Stephen Jones talking today. We'll talk about some of the things Stephen had to say. It's the time of year where you don't believe anything you hear, including from, I don't know, Stephen Jones. We'll talk about it next here on the Blitz on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star. If you're a business owner, a manager, a club leader, and you need your logo on any kind of gear, get into Sammy's Embroidery and Printing down on San Pedro. If you need t-shirts screen printed, maybe you're doing a fiesta event, you're working a booth, you need your shirts made, you need them done in a hurry, get over and see Sam. He'll get you taken care of. He'll get your t-shirts screen printed. If you need caps, Sam has over 25,000 caps and more than 75 color combinations on display in his showroom, including the popular Richardson 112 style trucker caps. If you need uniforms done, Sam has over 700 uniform lines to choose from. If you just need your logo on a nice golf shirt, a fishing shirt, any kind of shirt, a dress shirt, go see Sam. He'll get you taken care of. He's got all the big name brands like North Face, Eddie Bauer, Nike, Travis Matthew, Port Authority, to name a few. Sammy's Embroidery and Printing. Nobody has better prices. Sammy is the only company in Texas that offers one-day turnaround. No order too big, certainly no order too small, and all items do come with a warranty. Call 210-824-3900, 824-3900, or better yet, go by that massive showroom on San Pedro, 1 mile inside Loop 410, next to Big Lots across from McDonald's, or check the website, samsembroidery.com, for Sammy's Embroidery Club.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, we look back to the first play-ins. We get more tonight, and also the Spurs draft history. Looks like a 5 pick all the way through an 8. We'll look at the history of the Spurs in that order.
Plus, the NFL draft begins next Thursday night. Who are the Dallas Cowboys going to take in the first round? Who are the Houston Texans going to take when it's all said and done? I might convince Rob to do a mock draft. You don't want to miss it. The Morning Huddle starts at 6.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ. Morning 6 to 10 on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's AUDACY.
I spray and scrub, but the soap scum in my bathtub is still there.
I spray and scrub, but the burnt sauce on my stovetop sticks around.
Sprays can leave grime behind, but new Mr. Clean Ultra Foamy Magic Eraser combines the scrubbing power of an eraser with the cleaning power of Dawn to melt away tough messes on contact.
Just wet, squeeze, and erase.
Stop spraying, start erasing, and clean with more magic than ever with new Ultra Foamy Magic Eraser.
Mr. Clean.
Jake from State Farm. I'm winning. I finally cleaned my house, so I'm bringing out my new tropical room spray.
Keep winning and create an affordable price just for you by bundling your home and auto with the State Farm Personal Price Plan. It's like your own personal paradise.
Ooh, hey, grab me a coconut water.
Bundling, just another way to save with a personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Prices are based on rating plans that vary by state. Coverage options are selected by the customer. Availability, amount of discounts and savings, and eligibility vary by state.
If you can't sleep because of annoying knee pain, that's a problem. You stop running because your feet always hurt, that's a problem. If your elbow, shoulder, and neck pain make it impossible for you to do your job, that is a problem. And it's time to finally do something about it. I'm Dr. Jason Garrett from Erosti. At Erosti, we fix pain fast. No medications, no injections. Erosti treatment is completely natural and non-invasive. Plus, we accept most insurance plans. There's a location near you. Visit Erosti.com. That's AIRROSTI.com. Erosti, we fix pain fast.
Jason Minix here from the Blitz with the NBA playoffs here. You want to get in on the action and have fun watching the games the way I do? Make sure you download the Underdog Fantasy app and start playing their pick'em game, where you pick between 2 and 5 players to build a pick'em entry, select higher or lower on player stats. If your picks hit, you could win up to 100 times your money, endless projections to choose from. You create your own experience. It's a ton of fun to play. I love winning on the pick'em game, obviously. It is fantasy, but legal in Texas. is. So get signed up at underdogfantasy.com or download the Underdog Fantasy app. Use my promo code STAR when you sign up, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. Must be over 18 and present in a state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org. Again, promo code STAR when you sign up at underdogfantasy.com.
Step up your lunch game at Twin Peaks. We have the light and hearty combos put together for you starting at just $7.99, featuring savory soups, crisp salad, and a variety of sandwiches, and so much more to satisfy every craving. With four San Antonio area locations, enjoy your next lunch break at Twin Peaks. And Twin Peaks is hiring. Have a ton of fun and make great money. Currently looking for Twin Peaks girls, cooks, bussers, barbacks, and more. Text WORK, the number 4TP, to 85000 to apply. Twin Peaks eats, drinks, and oh, those scenic views.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob Thompson and RJ Ochoa.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, we are going to react to everything from Tuesday night's Western Conference play-in games and, of course, get you ready for the Eastern side. Plus, the NFL draft is getting closer and closer and closer. There's no panic around here. But speaking of panic, back to the Blitz. Jason, Joe, I heard you guys are starting to freak out about a whole bunch of different things. Are y'all good?
I'm not sure what we're freaking out about, RJ.
Not a thing. I'm freaking out because RJ's freaking out. I'm worried about him.
This is going to be a stressful week for RJ Ochoa.
Cowboys get his blood pressure high. They do.
I'm going to be on the Morning Huddle on Thursday morning. Yeah. Looking forward to that.
Nice.
I'd look forward to that a lot more if that show started later in the day.
Yeah, but, like 2 o'clock.
Yeah. Even 9 o'clock would be. Yeah, right.
that would be.
But from the kitchen table, I will be in on the Morning Huddle, and I will imagine there's going to be a lot of Cowboys talk with RJ Ochoa, and you know, and I love RJ, and I've known him for a long time. And so I say this all respectfully, but RJ Ochoa is one of those, if you're not doing it his way, you're doing it wrong. And the Cowboys aren't doing things his way, so clearly they are doing everything wrong.
Well, in that respect, I agree with him.
Well, we all have ideas on what needs to be done. Like, I don't know, signing Dak Prescott. Get that. I mean, you know, you've got these three big deals that you need to get done, and you keep saying you can't do anything else because those deals aren't done. So make it a priority to get those deals done. Stephen Jones on 105.3, the Fan today up in Dallas, was talking about Dak and everything going on with Dak and the criticism that he faces because, you know, of his fantastic playoff record.
Well, I think anytime you have a great quarterback, that's part of what comes with accountability when you certainly make the kind of money Dak's making. But he had a great year last year. He was, I think, number two in MVP voting. Had a great season. Unfortunately, we didn't do what we needed to do to beat the Packers, and so we've just got to continue, to figure out what's in the best interest of this football team in terms of making it better and giving it the best chance to have success in the playoffs. We understand completely until we go have success in the playoffs, there's going to be frustration. I mean, for three seasons, we've won 12 games, which is, I think, as much as anybody over a 3-year stretch, but we hadn't had success in the playoffs. And until that happens, we understand that we're going to be held accountable and people are going to look and have criticism.
Yeah. And I don't think the Jones family gives a damn about the criticism they're getting from the fans. Look, if you're going to surround Dak Prescott, you're not doing it. You're going to rely on a bunch of unknowns and on your offensive line. Maybe you're going to give him another weapon in Worthy if that comes out to be true.
Stop.
So, I don't know what they're doing. And I think that's the thing. And the lack of activity, even though they're not very active in the free agent period anyway, that's kind of their motive, the way they operate. But, man, it just seems like everybody else in that division has improved, at least on paper, and the Cowboys have not. And I heard on Greeny today, some even doubt a playoff spot as it stands right now.
Although, and it's so interesting because if you were to pull up right now, a Cowboys two deep, they've got guys in every position.
Sure.
Some of them are young guys that are unproven that have been on the roster for a while. And so when you look at trying to figure out what the Cowboys' plan is, and it does feel weird this year more than any other year, they're being a little bit more Spurs-like, and I think Cowboy fans don't know how to react to that, including RJ Ochoa, including me, including you, because the Cowboys generally tell us more than you should know. You go, man, I can't believe they just said that, right? That's what we're used to from the Cowboys.
Uh-huh.
And this year, we're not getting an idea of what their actual plan is, except for we know they've signed one external free agent.
Yes.
A linebacker that used to play for Mike Zimmer in Minnesota.
Uh-huh.
That originally was agreed to terms with a different team, but the Cowboys were able to get him.
San Francisco, I believe.
And that's it. That's all they've done as far as adding. You've seen a lot of people leave. And I maintain that if any of those guys they wanted to keep, they would have. So from that standpoint, they've lost some trust with last year's draft. The Cowboys, Jerry and Steven, there's never been a lot of trust with them running the show as football personnel guys. But if they feel like that they've got those guys that they've drafted and developed, which is what they like to do, and now you look at the two deep and you see a lot of those guys that they drafted and developed now listed as starters as they sit right now. All right. And then you keep hearing, well, we've got to sign Micah and we've got to sign CD and you got to sign Dak. Yet, by all accounts, they haven't had a lot of conversations, serious negotiations with any of those three guys at this point, is maddening.
It is. But say they sign all those guys. Say you get all those guys signed and they all get their big deals and they set the market and everything else because they're next, right? Where's the money coming from to do anything else? You're going to have to rely on these unproven guys.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to. You have no other choice because you're going to have those guys taking up all the oxygen in the room.
Sure. And again, all the guys that are proven at one point were unproven. So well, you don't know until you go. If you believe in your process and the Cowboys believe in their process, they don't give a damn if you believe in their process. They believe in their process. They draft and they develop, and then they like to pay their own guys, or they let them walk, like a Tyler Biadasz. They didn't feel that Tyler Biadasz was worth keeping around at the kind of money that he was going to command.
Mm-hmm. Or they couldn't keep him around. You say they could find the money, sure, if they wanted to keep him, but you've got to sign those three guys. Isn't that the expectation?
But again, though, if I know I've earmarked X for Dak, X for CD, and X for Micah.
And there's nothing left.
There is. There's plenty left.
Is there?
Well, you can redo this deal, redo that deal. I mean, we see it all the time. But then you look at Philadelphia, they sign guys early. They sign guys early.
Uh-huh.
Now, they know they want to keep a guy. They sign him early, just like the Eagles did this week. And they're known for doing that. But if you're the Eagles, sorry, some guy singing down the hallway. Could you hear that on the air? Yeah, could you? All right. If you are, the problem with signing guys early is they're back at the negotiating table that much sooner. It's a difference in philosophy on when you want to pay your guys. The Eagles, they get a lot of credit for signing guys early. You know, the Cowboys, they get a lot of grief for waiting until the last minute to get a deal done. You know, tax day just happened. Did you guys do your taxes and write that check to the IRS in January, or did you wait till Monday to write that check, right? If you're getting money back, you do it early. If you know you're going to pay, you do it on the deadline. The Cowboys work on a deadline.
Or you get an extension.
Deadlines make deals.
Yes.
Yeah, but there's no extensions here. Deadlines make deals. Well, and when the Cowboys are facing a deadline, they will get it done.
Well, they don't have a deadline with any of these guys until March.
Which is why there's no deals. Now, so, do I think that they will get a deal done with Dak before the start of the season? I do. I really do.
Uh-huh. Well, we'll see in the draft.
But
will tell you a lot.
Yes. If they take a quarterback high in the draft, then Well, then Dak is done in Dallas after one more year. If Dak gets traded, clearly he's done in Dallas.
But right.
Assuming they don't take a quarterback in the first round, then I would expect a deal with Dak to be done before the start of the season.
Well, it's a lot of drama. I'm just saying you're going to pay all of those guys and money's tight. And I can kind of see where Jerry and Steven are going with this thing. You know, can they find the money? Perhaps. Do you let, you know, veteran guys that are already proven walk out the door because you can't pay them or won't pay them and go with some guy that you hope has developed like you think? Again, you know, on practice and training camp is one thing. Sunday afternoon is a whole different thing. As we've seen in some of the players, Josh Ball comes to mind. He looked great in training camp. Sunday afternoon, not so much.
That happens.
It does.
There was a lot of expectation for Mozzie Smith last year.
Yeah.
And he did not have a rookie season that was stellar.
Right now on the depth chart, he's a backup. Isn't that funny?
It is.
You know, Chauncey Golston is your starter right now.
And again, with what you've seen from Mozzie, that makes a lot of sense until he can go prove it on the football field.
Sure.
It's for an offseason in which Jerry said we're going to be all in, they've done the opposite. And I think that's also a big part of the frustration from so many Cowboy fans. You get a guy like Jerry saying we're going to be all in. Whether he was actually talking about all in with the contracts of the guys on his team, which is exactly what he said, although he hasn't done that either.
No,
they weren't players in free agency. Steven was asked, hey, do you regret your dad saying that we're going to be all in?
No.
No? Okay.
You know, I think if you're not all in this league, you're all out. And I don't know of any of the 32 who aren't all in. And, you know, everybody can have their own definition of what that means, but I've never not known us to be all in, nor have I known anybody we compete against not to be all in. It's, you know, they have different strategies as to what that means, but at, you know, at the end of the day, if you're not really all in trying to figure out how to put together a championship football team, then you shouldn't be in this league.
Your definition of what is all in and mine might not be the same thing.
You know, and that might be very true. That really might be very true. But in reality, the Cowboys are a PR machine.
No doubt.
They understand. Jerry understands. Steven understands when Jerry says all in, what the expectation of the fan base is when you say that, even if you might define it differently. You don't say that flippantly. I mean, I agree with Steven on word for word with what he said. All 32 teams are trying to win a Super Bowl.
It's just the definition is different of all in.
When fans hear a team say, yeah, we're going all in, that means we're free agency, salary cap be damned. We're going to do everything we can to win a Super Bowl right now. And if it costs us a couple of bad years down the road, we'll deal with that. But we're going all in. I mean, you know, it's the pregame speech. It's the right. It's all of that. So don't say it if you don't really mean it, or you're going to deal with the frustration that fans have. This is the first offseason in a long time that you recall Cowboy fans being this down on their football team.
Absolutely.
And to Steven's point, they've won 36 games over the last 3 years, which is damn good, except for they haven't done squat in the playoffs. And that's the problem.
This year was the worst.
Embarrassing. And Steven says, you know, put that on me. We take responsibility for those results.
I feel as accountable as anybody in terms of the success of this franchise. And of course, you know, we want to have one of the top, if not the top, franchise, you know, in the country, if not the world. And I think, you know, certainly I think we do in terms of what our brand's valued at. We certainly want to have more success on the field in terms of that part of it. But, you know, as I said, we've had a lot of success during the regular season. We haven't had the success in the postseason. And we just, you know, until we do that, we understand there'll be frustration. And I can tell you this, we'll be rolling up our sleeves and going to work.
Yeah, go to work. Roll up them sleeves.
I don't blame the Jones family for last year's debacle. They had a team around them. Everything laid out perfectly for them. They got lucky as hell that Philadelphia collapsed. It was all right there. 15-game winning streak at home. They had two games in front of them at home before they had to hit the road possibly for the NFC Championship game. And the players let them down. I mean, it's just that simple. I don't blame Jerry and Steven for last year. To me, that roster, that group had every chance imaginable, and the cards fell just right, and the players laid an egg, not Jerry and Steven.
Yeah, but Jerry and Steven are ultimately in charge. And, you know,
you can only put players out there. You can't play for them.
Well, this is true. I mean, and Mike McCarthy didn't miss a tackle or throw an interception or a pick six, right?
Exactly right.
But at the same time, the group wasn't ready to go. And you might not blame Jerry and Steven, but they're at the top. They're the ones that should be taking accountability.
How are they supposed to get the players ready to play?
Well,
Jerry and Steven,
look.
They're writing the checks. The checks aren't bouncing.
When you're evaluating, though, I mean, do you got the guys with the mental toughness to play in a big moment? Because every one of those guys played like they weren't ready for the moment.
Well, then maybe you look at the roster and you get rid of everybody and start over. I mean, seriously.
I mean,
blow it up. Start over. If that's the case,
Jerry's,
if those guys aren't mentally tough enough, then okay, I guess that's Jerry and Steven's fault.
I mean,
so, but they still want $60 million a year,
of course,
even though they're not mentally tough enough.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So Jerry and Steve is still supposed to write that check.
Yeah, absolutely.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay.
And you wonder why there's hesitation to give them a contract.
Absolutely. It is. And uh-huh. I don't blame them at all. Blow it up and start over.
They're not doing that.
Well, they should.
They're not with Jerry at 80.
Well,
something.
Obviously they've put a bunch of weak mental minded folks on the field. So they ought to get rid of all of them if they're weak and mentally not tough.
Yeah.
It's easy to blame Jerry and Steven when the players go out there and I need to be motivated to play.
I don't know about
in a playoff game.
What you've been paying attention to, but I think more of the blame has gone on those players, especially number four.
It's exactly
and,
where it needs to be.
In 88 and 11 uh-huh. than on Jerry and Steven.
Well, that's where it needs to be.
It's exactly where it needs
absolutely.
To be.
Absolutely.
But I appreciate it. He's the boss. He takes accountability.
Well, okay. It's easy to say now.
That's you my know, fault. Everybody can have their own definition of what that means, but I've never not known us to be all in.
Mm-hmm. They're all in.
All in.
All in.
Yes.
Takes a lot of energy to talk about the Dallas Cowboys.
Sure does.
If you've been dealing with a lack of energy, maybe a little motivation, low libido, those could all be symptoms caused by low T levels. At Synergenics, their medical providers exclusively specialize in customized testosterone treatment, and they make it quick and easy to get your levels checked. And at Synergenics, you will get your results back at your first visit because they have an on-site lab. Locations all over San Antonio. So book your appointment now at fixmylowt.com. Your testosterone levels start to decline in your 30s. So if you're feeling a lack of energy and drive, get your levels tested at Synergenics. Think about that energy you had in your 20s, in your 30s. You want to get back to feeling like you did at Synergenics. You will get customized care from testosterone specialists. The important thing is to go get tested. You got to know what that number is. So take that first step. Book your appointment now. FixMyLowT.com is the website. That's FixMyLowT.com.
Riding I-35 with the Blitz. Afternoons 2 to 6, KTFM Floresville, and everywhere at sasportstar.com.
Our daughter Jessie loves playing detective.
A clue.
But since we discovered she has sensitive skin, we've been playing detective too.
We thought the problem was our puppy.
But it was actually our old detergent.
Aha. Uh-huh.
So we switched to Tide Free and Gentle. Tide cleans better than the leading competitive free detergent, and it doesn't leave behind irritating residues.
Plus, Tide Free and Gentle has no dyes or perfumes, so it's gentle on her skin.
Case closed.
If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide Free and Gentle.
I want to learn how to cook, but I keep ordering takeout.
Accomplishing goals is hard, but when your goal is to learn a new language, Babbel makes it easy.
In just 15 minutes a day, Babbel will help you start having conversations in as little as 3 weeks. Words and phrases you'll actually use. So when someone asks,
"How's your French going?"
you can say,
"Babbel facilite grandement l'apprentissage d'une nouvelle langue."
Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Wesley Financial Group is not a law firm.
This story is called The Ugly Truth About Timeshare. If you think you've done your family a favor by buying a timeshare, you need my help. Hello, I'm Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group. 10 years ago, I started helping folks cancel their timeshare. In the process, started what's now called the timeshare cancellation industry. The ugly truth is when you buy a timeshare, you can't tell me how much it's going to cost or when it's going to end. I recently helped a couple that had their maintenance fees go from $800 to $3,200 a year. They also received a $4,000 assessment for a hurricane that was over 1,000 miles away. Sound crazy? The crazy thing is, this never ends. Call my office now. If we take you as a client, I guarantee we'll cancel your timeshare or you'll pay nothing.
Call for your free information kit. Call 800-462-3333. That's 800-462-3333. 800-462-3333.
Guys, did you know your testosterone affects everything in your system, including how you feel and perform every day? Right now, Revive Men's Health San Antonio will check your testosterone for free. Knowing your T levels is the first step in understanding if you have low T. Your testosterone level impacts your energy, libido, sleep, weight, hair loss, mood, and even ED. Maintaining an appropriate T level can change your whole life. Most men start to see changes in their hormone levels in their 30s. Experience and results matter. So what are you waiting for? Get your T levels checked today by local, experienced, and trusted men's health experts. They've helped thousands of men since 2011. They're so confident they can help you, they even guarantee it. Call Revive today and schedule your free testosterone test, free exam, and free consultation. Call Revive Men's Health at 210-615-7777. That's 210-615-7777. Or visit RevivemensHealth.com.
Hey, it's Rob Thompson here for Prize Picks. It's America's number one sports fantasy act. 3 million players? Yes, I'm a member. You should be too. Download it now and remember the code Alamo, and you can get a deposit match of up to $100. Basketball is falling, baby. Football is coming. Baseball is swinging. It is time to go to Prize Picks because you put your fantasy knowledge into action. You know more. You know you're less. You know who's better or not. You know what's going on. You're a fantasy player. Put that knowledge to work. I have, along with so many others. And right now, remember the code Alamo, and you can get a $100 deposit match right now. Go download Prize Picks. We love watching Connor McDavid, Jude Bellingham, LeBron James. They are playing go more or less. It's so easy to do, and now's the time to go. You know when it's more. You know when it's less. And when you pair them together, you can win big, big bucks, up to 100 times your money. More, less, Prize Picks, Alamo. Go there.
You're listening to 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Sports Center.
Could the Cowboys actually take a wide receiver with the 24th overall pick? NFL Network's Peter Schrager's mock draft has them doing exactly that. The playoffs begin tonight, kind of. It's the play-in tournament. New Orleans, they'll take on the Lakers as the 7-8 matchup at 6:30. That will be followed by the Kings and the Warriors, the 9-10 matchup at 9 o'clock. Both games televised on TNT.
SportsCenter is brought to you by Byers Barricades, the Texas authority in barricade rental. ByersBarricades.com.
Joe Reinagle.
That's the third time in 7 seasons the San Antonio Spurs are the NBA champions.
Jason Minnitz.
They go back to big day as Super Bowl champions. Dallas 52, Buffalo 17.
It's the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minnix. Glad to have you along on this Tuesday afternoon.
Happy Tuesday, everybody. We can't see outside. I wonder, has it cleared up any at all?
I have no idea.
I mean, I'm kind of curious.
For the record, what Joe is really trying to brag about is he's 2 hours into the show and has not had to pee yet.
You keep track of that or what?
No, but... You know, I realized you have not left the studio.
No, I have, actually.
Since the show started.
I did. Now, I was walking in there to get some water, and I saw Greg Shelton coming out. Uh-huh. He had this goofy look on his face.
Coming out of where?
The bathroom.
Uh-oh.
And I'm like, whoa. I didn't want to go in there after that.
Oh,
I was afraid.
So you're holding it.
Well, yeah. Okay. I'll go at the next break. I mean, when you see Shelton walking out of the bathroom with a real goofy look on his face.
Well, isn't that his normal
look? Well, I guess kind of.
I mean, you know, I just think he was in there blowing things up.
I don't know what he was in there doing. I have no clue.
You weren't willing to risk it?
I was not. I was not. Would you have?
No.
I guess it depends on how bad you got to go.
Well, that's it.
Wow. I didn't know you kept up with my my pee habits.
I don't, except for you not to have walked down the hall in 2 hours.
Dude, I have. I've got two bottles of water.
Are you refilling it or just going in the office and grabbing a bottle?
I'm refilling it.
All right.
Hey, I'm a.
Just don't leave that in here. We gotta clean the studio.
I know.
Rob's in trouble.
That's
how I say that. Rob's in trouble. If you're watching on YouTube, and subscribe to the San Antonio Sports Star YouTube channel.
I'll move the camera over.
So Rob has a collection of bobbleheads in the corner of the studio. And apparently they're going to do some work in the studio and do some rewiring. So they need the counter space in the studio cleaned up. And we got that email this morning. I heard Rob even mention it on the show. But did Rob stick around today and clean up his mess?
No. Well, because the email says we have until Thursday.
Well, but Rob's not even going to be here Thursday.
Just saying.
He's taking Thursday off. So tomorrow
he's got to take care of it.
He's going to clean out and go put all that stuff in his office. Because then it was like, well, what all in here is yours? Nothing.
I have a feeling that some cool things are coming. I just have that feeling.
Really?
Well, I don't know. I mean, you've been here longer than me, but
good luck.
You get an email like that, I'm thinking, well, hey,
yeah,
get a little upgrade, maybe some 80s carpet instead of 70s.
Oh, they're not going to do that. It's rewiring.
Oh, rewiring.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, some of the stuff that's underneath this counter right here that hasn't been used in 12 years, I think they're going to pull all that stuff out and try to sell it on Facebook Marketplace.
All right.
I know we're getting a new monitor in here. And they're going to talk about mounting some cameras.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
We'll see that. Cool stuff.
But we're not going to get rid of the shag carpet. That's not even shag carpet.
It's not shag. I don't know.
But the carpet that's been on the walls for 15 years. And, you know, I think it gets vacuumed every 3 or 4 years.
Does it
which
really?
Which is why everybody here deals with allergy issues. When you walk into the studio.
It must be every 3 or 4 years because it hasn't been done since I got here. I've been here like 2.5 years now.
Yeah. I know they did a pretty decent job during the COVID timeframe of cleaning the walls.
Uh-huh. Well, now that COVID's over, then the hell with it.
Yeah.
Not doing it.
Well, see, Pledge, there's times, though, where if we're here and I see the cleaning crew, I'll ask them, like, hey, can you vacuum the carpet, vacuum the walls, or, hell, vacuum the floors in here? Because half the time...
Well, I think they do that.
Well, not very often.
No?
Because the cleaning crew is here while we're on the air, and so they don't come in here.
Ah.
You know, it's like sometimes our trash doesn't get emptied. You've got to set the trash can outside the studio door.
I think it'd be kind of cool one day when they're out there. We'll just invite them in while we're on the air.
And have them vacuum?
Sure.
Sure, that's great.
Why not? Yeah, it is. Yeah, we think outside the box, Minix.
Yeah.
Who else does a radio show with people vacuuming the studio? Nobody. That's what I'm talking about. We're trailblazers.
Yeah. We try to create great radio here.
Uh-huh.
That just doesn't sound like it'd be great radio.
Well, you never know till you try.
I really have an idea that trying to talk over a vacuum probably wouldn't be great radio. It would be difficult for us and annoying as hell for the people listening.
Well, it would. What's that little push one that makes no noise? Remember those?
Yeah, no.
It's like a fancy broom.
Yeah, that's not what they use.
A Dyson?
I don't know what brand it is, but it doesn't make any noise.
How do you know?
Well, that's what the commercial said.
Oh, okay. When was the last time you pushed a vacuum?
It's been a while.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's been a while.
When was the last time you were around when the vacuum was being pushed by somebody else?
I've been around for that. I don't have a lot of carpet in my house, though.
Yeah.
Just, there's a couple of rooms that have carpet, but not many. Most of it's floor flooring.
Flooring?
Well, not carpet.
You're an idiot. It's called tile.
Well, that, yes, tile.
Maybe you have wood floors. No, I've been to your house. It's all tile.
I don't have wood.
Just like my house. I have tile in every room in my house. The only carpet in my house is the two guest rooms, which rarely get used. And then I've got a Roomba that goes every morning to clean the floors.
Well, that just reminds me of the Roomba. You had nightmares about that. Now, I know you don't have pets at the moment.
No.
But, you know, sometimes Roombas, they hit that pile of poo and they don't stop.
And
they drag it all over the house.
See, that wasn't the nightmare that I had. My dogs thankfully never pooped in the house. I had good dogs. I never had that situation. Rob Thompson has had that situation.
Yes, I've had that situation. Not with a Roomba, but the poo.
Well, get a Roomba and it takes that poo on the floor.
Sure, and it's even
more. But one time, Roomba tried to kill my dog Princess. And it was one of the scarier things that I've ever had to deal with, right? And one of those nightmare things that, you know, Princess was old. And, I mean, we had her 17 years.
Yeah.
And she came from the pound. And when we got her from the pound, they said she was between 2 and 4. This is an old dog.
Hey, 20-year-old dog.
And Princess was the best. But she got used to the Roomba, so it didn't bother her anymore. So when Roomba's doing her thing, Roomba had to go around Princess, right? Well, Princess had kind of a furry tail. One time Roomba tried to go over that furry tail and the tail got caught up. And so Princess trying to get up and the Roomba's attached to the back of her and she can't move and trying to untangle and cut the dog hair tail out of the Roomba.
Wow.
That was a terrifying 20 minutes.
I'm sure.
Because the dog was completely freaked out and wouldn't sit still and Roomba's still trying to go.
Well, you'd be freaked out too if a Roomba was all wrapped up in your tail. Jeez.
You know, when we first got Roomba, the dogs were trying to attack it.
Yeah, sure.
You know, what's this? You know, but they would never really get close enough. You know, dogs with the front legs, they get down there and they, you know, and they're trying to, and then Princess would just sleep. Roomba, go around me. I'm not getting up for you. Roomba said, the hell with you, man.
Yeah,
go over your tail and attack the dog.
Yeah.
That was terrifying.
That's
the noise that dog was making, I didn't know was possible.
Oh, sure.
I mean, seriously. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. It was, I thought my dog was going to die by Roomba. all of it, either heart attack, stroke, all of the above, fear. I mean, it was, you know, eaten alive by Roomba. That was a terrifying day.
I'm sure it was.
I'm glad you're sympathetic.
That was a great dog.
It was.
It was a great dog.
And then I had the Basset Hound. Now I'm dogless.
Well, I got two dogs.
Mm-hmm.
One of my dogs is the best knees money can buy.
Joe's got a dog that's literally called Has Bad Knees. It's in the name, and he wonders why he's got to do a couple of ACL and knee replacement surgeries.
She's great right now. I'll tell you what. Jump and run.
But how's the landing?
Well, it's fine. You know, it's crazy because I don't know how that happens.
What?
The knee. She blew out two knees. How the hell does that happen?
On a dog?
Yes.
I'm not going to ask because I know your wife's out of town.
Yes. She
is. How you pay for two ACL surgeries on a dog?
Well, it was a special.
It wasn't.
Buy one leg, get the other
and
free.
It wasn't.
You know, it's nuts how that happens. She loves to chase like toys.
Yeah, of course.
She's got
a dog.
Basket full of these, you know, stuffed animals.
Dog doing dog things.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, the other one doesn't.
What?
The other one just lays there like, the hell with that. Look at that foolish dog. You know, I mean, it's like, they don't give a damn.
Mm-hmm.
But she's fine now.
No, she's fine
in case
now.
You're wondering. I mean, she's great.
Do you have pet insurance?
No.
Oh, you should.
Well, and anybody out there listening, if you got a puppy, buy the pet insurance. Do it. Your friendly advice from your old Uncle Joe right here. Buy the pet insurance.
Or, you know, when the vet says it's going to cost you the price of a new small car to get a new knee for your dog, you say, no, I'll go get another dog.
Well, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'd be on the outside before that dog. Yeah.
Not once, but twice.
I know my role in the family. That dog... He is higher on the food chain than I am. All right.
Absolutely.
So yeah, I know better.
Yeah, it's one thing if your dog is dealing with knee injuries, but if you are dealing with an injury, you know you can skip the ER and get straight to an OrthoNow injury clinic by TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine. OrthoNow provides walk-in care for injuries like broken bones, dislocations, sprains, strains, ACLs. Yep. Conveniently located in the Cory area with extended hours Monday through Saturday. They have on-site x-ray casting and bracing. OrthoNow has everything you need to treat your injury, but best of all, no urgent care or emergency room copay. So if you're injured, get to an OrthoNow injury clinic. Learn more online at TSAOG.com. That's TSAOG.com.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, we look back to the first play-ins. We get more tonight, and also the Spurs draft history. Looks like a 5 pick all the way through an 8. We'll look at the history of the Spurs in that order.
Plus, the NFL draft begins next Thursday night. Who are the Dallas Cowboys going to take in the first round? Who are the Houston Texans going to take when it's all said and done? I might convince Rob to do a mock draft. You don't want to miss it. The Morning Huddle starts at 6.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ. Mornings 6 to 10 on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's AUDACY.
Tired of hearing scary radio ads about the IRS? Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000 or $500,000, we have a solution. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS with zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. We have over 1,000 five-star reviews on Google and an A-plus with a BBB. End your tax nightmare today by visiting TRA.com or call 800-583-6580. That's 800-583-6580.
By texting 64,000, you agree to receive recurring automated marketing messages from Babbel. Message and data rates may apply. No purchase required. Terms apply. Available at babbel.com/TNC.
What's keeping you from learning the language you've always wanted to speak?
Too hard.
Takes too long.
Not with Babbel. Babbel's lessons make learning fun.
Fun isn't hard.
Right. And in 10 minutes a day, Babbel's bite-sized lessons are designed to get you having real conversations in as little as 3 weeks.
That's not long.
It's not hard.
It's perfect.
It starts here. And now try Babbel for free by texting radio to 64,000. Text radio to 64,000.
You're going to feel a puff of air.
Zhong's Optometry has set their sights on staffing up.
Try the next line. Hey, Kim, can you tell our 2 o'clock we're running 15 behind? Sorry, we're a bit backed up today.
He needs an optometric technician to keep an eye on it all.
Where are the dilation drops?
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
With Spring Black Friday savings at the Home Depot, you can get up to $2,300 off select kitchen packages from top brands like GE Profile. That means you can save on a new GE Profile smart quad door refrigerator that's full of convenient features like a dual dispense auto fill pitcher and an ice dispenser with up to 12.5 pounds capacity. Bring convenience to your kitchen with smart, innovative appliances from GE Profile. Right now, save up to $2,300 on select kitchen packages with Spring Black Friday savings at the Home Depot. How doers get more done.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. 120,000 miles of night drives, daily commutes, and who knows how many.
Are we there yet?
Through countless fixes, elbow grease, and a new radiator, you kept your ride alive. With eBay Motors, you have over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Stirring fiber, exercising, frequent trips to the store for more laxatives and fiber. Sounds like your constipation with belly pain is a lot to manage. But if your symptoms that keep coming back are signs of irritable bowel syndrome with constipation, or IBS-C, ask your doctor how Linzess can help you get ahead of it. Linzess Linaclotide is a prescription medicine that treats IBS-C in adults. It's not a laxative. It's a once-daily pill that helps you get ahead of your symptoms. It's proven to help you have more frequent and complete bowel movements and helps relieve overall abdominal symptoms, belly pain, discomfort, and bloating. These symptoms were studied in combination, not individually. Do not give Linzess to children less than 2. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stools. The most common side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas, stomach area pain, and swelling. Learn more at Linzess.com or call 1-800-LINZESS.
The Jim Rome Show, weekdays at noon.
I love San Antonio, man. I love it.
On 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minix. Former Bernie Star quarterback Quentin Dormandy is the new starter for the San Antonio Brahmas. He's been the backup, injury to the starter in last week's game against St. Louis. Chase Garbers looks like he's out for the season. Dormandy, the new starter, he will join us in about 15 minutes from right now.
That's awesome. You know, it's a good opportunity for him. I'm sorry for, you know, the injury issue, but good for Dormandy.
Absolutely.
And good opportunity.
Well, it is. And, you know, I think about from high school, his various stops in college. Quentin has dealt with injury issues throughout his career.
Sure.
There was a time in high school you thought, man, he's destined for the NFL, and he's trying to work his way back up there, but he's got to stay healthy. Gets a great opportunity here with the San Antonio Brahmas. Again, Dormandy will join us coming up at 4:35. And another football star locally here with some big news as well. Former Clemens quarterback.
We watched this kid grow up, you and I, basically, right?
Max DiDomenico.
And I can finally say his last name.
Yes.
DiDomenico.
It's only taken you 15
years.
It
took a long time. Yeah. I used to ask his dad all the time, Gino, out there, and how do you say it again?
Yeah.
And I don't know how many times he pronounced it for me, but Max is the captain of the Army football team for the 2024 season. That's a great honor, and man, I'm so happy for him.
You
the
know,
whole family.
I think about, and they're such good people.
Absolutely.
And I remember trying to learn how to say his name at the San Antonio All-Star football game because I kept butchering it. But here's a guy who commits to Army. You know, he's a quarterback. You're going to go to Army and play safety. And he has been a stud there. And we have a tradition every year of taking a picture with Max DiDomenico
yes.
on the field after the Army-Navy game. That's become a great tradition. This year, we get to do it with the team captain.
Absolutely.
Which is cool. They named 4 captains for the Army football team after their spring run. And a local kid from San Antonio captaining, is that a word? The Army football team is pretty freaking awesome.
Well, Max was the star of the game last year. I mean, he was. So yeah, it's always good, but man, fond memories of the DiDomenicos, and saying their name and watching that kid play. He was something else at Clemens.
Absolutely. Very cool. Team captain of Army football. One
Congratulations,
of team
man.
Captains for Army football is
huge
is
honor.
Very, very cool. Quite the honor. And he's such a good kid.
Too. Oh yeah.
I mean, I think it kind of goes without saying, if you're going to a service academy, you're a pretty squared away kid.
Yeah, I would say.
The term in the military, you're a squared away soldier. He certainly is, but nice guy. So congrats to Max DiDomenico on being named a team captain for Army. Go Navy. But yeah.
You're just irritated. Well, yeah, both games I've been to, Army has won.
Well, I mean, you know, Navy had like a 17-year winning streak.
I'm just saying.
Or 14, whatever the case is.
I mean, I've been to 2, and Army's won both of them.
They have. And again, it's one of those games. I grew up Army, but I was in the Navy. And, you know, we'll go back and forth with it. But, you know, ultimately, you're, you know, brothers for 364 days.
Well, they'll probably win again this year.
Just one. We'll see. We'll see. Congrats, Max, man. Happy
yes,
for you. Happy
yes.
for your family. That is freaking awesome.
That is awesome.
Hey, Ray, you're on the Blitz. What's up, man? Ray.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
How you doing, Joe? How you doing, Jason?
Good.
Good.
I want to give a shout out to our San Antonio Brahmas. It was my grandson's birthday this past Sunday. And man, they really treated him well. They showed him a real good time. He got to meet some of the players. They posted it on Instagram. So he's all happy about that. Of course, he sees all the views and everything. And man, number 10, Justin Smith. He's the one that was on the video throwing the ball with my grandson and everything. And just want to give everybody, you know, a reminder to support the Brahmas. That's our team. And man, they really treat the fans well.
You know, Ray, I mean, it's awesome. And I'm glad that your grandson, and I think the fan experience with the players, you know, at this level of football, they know they've got to do a little bit more. And it's tough when, you know, they're in Arlington most of the time. They come to town the day before the game when they have a home game and they're here, and then they got to go back to work up in Arlington. But I do think they do a really good job of trying to be a part of the community, not just in San Antonio, but throughout the UFL.
Sure.
Even though they're not practicing and living there, you know, 7 days a week. They do a good job. Speaking of the Brahmas, they just announced their Fiesta medal that
they'll have
for this year.
Wow.
That's cool looking Fiesta medal.
All right.
Yep.
You gonna get one?
Huh?
You gonna get one?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not a big Fiesta medal guy.
I'm not a medal guy either.
But I know
for a lot
of people out there,
they are.
But yeah, I'll hang it on my bulletin board in there.
Okay. Yeah.
If I get, it's a cool looking medal.
That's along with your certificates of the 12 and 5 seasons, right?
Sure, Dad. Sure.
That's a special place. That's all I'm saying. The Brahmas ought to be proud.
Yeah.
I mean, those certificates for 12 and 5 the last 3 years. Woo!
Mm-hmm. Everything with you comes back to the Cowboys when there's nothing to do with that.
I mean,
you want to turn this into a Cowboys segment? We're going to talk about the play-in games.
I'm just saying, I just admire your certificates in there.
There's not a single certificate in there, and you know it. There's Fiesta medals hanging on there, pins or buttons from various events, credentials.
I know.
Uh-huh. There's not a single certificate in there. You lied to the people.
I thought there was. I thought there were three of them in a row.
You just lied to the people.
I just thought there were three of them.
No,
right,
man, I got rid of the three and just made one for 36 regular season wins.
That's good.
You know?
Yes.
I mean, now granted, you know, Joe talks about me and my Cowboy certificate. You know, when we do our HR training, Joe prints out his certificate that says he has completed this course.
Yeah, right.
And he hangs that above his desk.
Sure.
Did you finish this last one?
I did. We had to do a driving safety course.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. I was supposed to bring beer in here today, wasn't it?
Yeah, you forgot again.
Well, there's tomorrow.
You didn't leave it on my driveway either. I checked the cameras. I was thirsty.
You were thirsty. Well, I'm a bachelor, right? So we can go have a beer after the show. I mean, you know.
You got to go home and take care of those expensive dogs.
Exactly. But then I can go have a beer after that.
Mm-hmm. So, then you got to go home and let the dogs out. Does Maggie FaceTime the dogs when she's out of town?
No, no, she doesn't.
You sure?
I sent her a picture of them though. Cause like when I got up this morning, the dog, it's funny how dogs don't lay like humans do. They got to lay the other way, right? So take up the whole damn bed. I got a whole king size bed and I'm like squished in the middle.
Uh-huh.
And the dogs are right up there.
How are you squished in the middle?
Well, because the dogs, I got one dog on one side and one on the other. And if I move once, it's like, whoa, okay, it's time to get up. Where are the treats?
All of a sudden, he's sleeping with Scooby-Doo.
Dude. I mean,
you got little dogs, not a Great Dane. Great Dane does take up the entire bed.
Yes.
Your dogs are smaller than the pillow. They should not be squishing you.
I'm telling you, they are.
They don't turn into super stretch dogs when they're laying there.
Well,
I mean, those dogs are so little, I'd be worried I'd roll over and squish one.
I don't know if they get cold or what, but they feel like they have to lay right up against you.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but they do. Oh, boy.
So bad.
Oh, man.
Good Lord.
What were we talking about?
I have no idea.
Oh, certificates on the wall in there.
No, no. Play-in. You got two play-in games tonight.
Yeah.
Who you got?
Both on TNT.
Well, we know the Pelicans are going to win because the Lakers are going to throw it.
We don't know that, Joe.
So, what's the line on that thing? I got to put a bet on the Pelicans tonight since LeBron and company are throwing the game.
What is the line? New Orleans by a point and a half. The total is 224.5.
Well, I'm taking New Orleans, laying them.
And the under?
Because I don't think Davis is playing, sincerely. I mean, he's questionable for sure.
So you got Lakers and Pelicans at 6:30, and then the Warriors and Kings at 9.
I think that's going to be a hell of a game.
That should be a really good game.
I'm looking forward to taking in that. See, it's going to be nice and quiet at my house. I can just sit there and watch the basketball game. It's going to be great.
Uh-huh.
Nice.
You're liking this bachelor stuff a little too much.
For a little while.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm ready for mama to come home.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I am.
It's been 2 days.
It has.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, remember how the show started?
Yeah. Exactly. And if you missed it, check the audio vault. Powered by AA Best Bail Bonds at SASportsStar.com.
That was ESPN's fault.
Uh-huh. Quentin Dormandy joins us next here on The Blitz, the new San Antonio Brahmas starting quarterback. You think about the two play-in games tonight. If you want to have a little bit more excitement watching those games, make sure you go download the Underdog Fantasy app or go to UnderdogFantasy.com and start playing the Pick'em game. Fan favorite way to play fantasy sports because, well, it's play-in time. You want to add some excitement to it? Play that pick'em game. Love playing the pick'em game where you pick between 2 and 5 players to build your pick'em entry and select higher or lower on a player's predicted stats. Your picks hit, you could win up to 100 times your money. It's fantasy, but legal in Texas, and trust me, a ton of fun to play and super easy to get started. Just download the app or go to the website, underdogfantasy.com. Sign up using my promo code STAR, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they will give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. Must be over 18 and present in a state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org. Again, sign up using my promo code STAR at underdogfantasy.com.
It's the 2024 NFL Draft on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
We're the 24th pick. The Dallas Cowboys select
April 25th, 26th, and 27th. Join 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star for this year's NFL Draft, live from Detroit.
I love the tenacity and the aggression with which he plays. He is a mauler.
Who do the Cowboys and Texans pick? Does Jerry make a splash? Who goes number one? And who's the next Mr. Irrelevant?
The Houston Texans select C.J. Stroud.
I don't ever want to pass on the guy you ought to be taking, David. Still, be position select.
I thought Sauce Gardner would be the first corner, but you go back to 2019, and that version of Derek Stingley is as good as anybody in this entire draft class.
Find out right here on your exclusive home for the NFL Draft. 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Hey, poker players, the Big Blind is open. With a true Vegas feel, the Big Blind is the premier poker room in San Antonio, featuring an upscale environment catering to players from all abilities. Whether you are seeking high-octane tournaments or lively cash games, the Big Blind has a game for everyone. The Big Blind at 281 in Redland Road, just down from the Rue Pub, offers daily cash games to daily, weekly, and monthly tournaments. Learn more online at thebigblindsa.com. The Big Blind at 281 in Redland Road.
George gets justice. In life's most challenging moments, getting the right help matters most if you've been injured. Get George at George Salinas Injury Lawyers. With a track record of success and a dedication to their clients, George gets justice. George Salinas Injury Lawyers is not just a law firm. They're your support system. Get George at George Salinas Injury Lawyers today at 210-225-0909 or visit getgeorge.com. George gets justice. GetGeorge.com.
We all hear the radio ads about the IRS. They tell you to be afraid, to be scared, and they try to frighten you into calling.
I'm not here to do that. Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000, $50,000, or $500,000, we have a solution. It doesn't matter if you're sitting in your car, at work, or with your kids, no matter where you are, call now. 800-575-9313. Don't lose hope. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS. There is zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. Our passion is taxes and helping individuals fix their IRS problems. We have a 5-star rating on Google and an A+ with the Better Business Bureau. You don't need to be afraid of the IRS any longer. End your tax nightmare today by visiting us online at TRA.com or call 800-575-9313. That's 800-575-9313. Tax Relief Advocates, real solutions for real people.
Over the past decade, the Roof Hub has proven to be the best place to watch games with those three massive 170-inch screens and TVs all around. All the games, all the UFC fights, and when you show up at the Roof Hub, show up hungry. The food is fantastic. Open daily at 11, great for lunch, great for dinner, great for late at night, and certainly the best place to watch a game. The Roof Hub is next to the Angry Elephant and in the same plaza as the Big Blind there at 281 in Redland Road. We'll see you at the Roof.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkamp, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkamp leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 210-571-0318. That's 210-571-0318. 210-571-0318.
Byers Barricades is proud to provide traffic control rental and sales for work zones and events in the San Antonio area and beyond. Byers Barricades, the Texas authority in barricade rental. Learn more online at buyersbarricades.com. That's buyersbarricades.com.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1, a San Antonio sports star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minix. You know, tomorrow about this time, we'll talk with Wade Phillips.
Wednesdays with Wade.
Yep. Head coach of the San Antonio Brahmas. We'll probably ask him about his new quarterback, but we're talking to that new quarterback right now as Quentin Dormandy joined us on the Byers Barricades guest line, former star out at Bernie. Now the starting quarterback of the San Antonio Brahmas. Quentin, man, how's your Tuesday going?
Going well. How about you guys?
Good.
Doing well. I would imagine this week a little bit different for you, although I want to go back to when Chase Garbers was injured, because I was at the game on Sunday. I never saw him get hurt, although the play that I've been told is when he did hurt himself when he got hit out of bounds. He stayed with it. But were you thinking you were going to get into the game on Sunday against St. Louis?
I always go in to the game with that mindset. So I was ready, but obviously, you know, talking with Chase kind of when it happened and noticing that he was in a little bit of pain. But he said he was good. So, you know, just continued to help him in the ways that I could.
You know, Quentin, it's interesting. When we talked to Wade before the season began, he said the competition between you two guys was very, very close. So I would imagine the confidence of the football team with you under center has just got to be, hey, we're just moving on. We've got a great quarterback under center.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's kind of the vibe on the team right now. Obviously, it sucks when anyone gets hurt, but you know, I think there shouldn't be a whole lot of transition, really. Just, you know, other than me getting more reps during practice and that kind of thing, and then going out and trying to put points on the board.
Quentin Dormandy joining us here on the Blitz, the new starting quarterback for the San Antonio Brahmas. They take on Michigan Saturday night in at the Alamo Dome, starting at 6 o'clock. from a prep standpoint, mindset standpoint, I know every backup quarterback goes into a game saying that they prepare as if they're a starter. But when you go from the backup role to, you know, this week you are getting to start, how does your prep change this week?
Honestly, it doesn't. Like you said, I mean, you know, that's what every quarterback says, but I look at myself as a starting quarterback. And, you know, the only thing really that's going to change, like I mentioned before, is, you know, me getting more reps as the backup. You know, during the week, you only get really a handful of reps of your plays. And then, you know, you're running scout team and stuff like that. So you're still getting live action, but not necessarily your offensive plays. So that's kind of the only difference right now. I think, you know, had walkthrough today, so things went well, and you know, starting to get install in for this weekend, and we'll go from there. But all is going well so far.
Well, Quentin, going into the game in the Alamo Dome, San Antonio, I mean, you know, right here in your backyard, that's got to feel pretty good. I would imagine you're going to be very comfortable running into that Alamo Dome and kicking off that football game.
Yeah, no doubt. I'm excited about the opportunity, obviously, to get back out there and play. And then obviously in front of a lot of people that have seen me play in the past, will be a pretty cool experience. My family was already planning to come down to the game and stuff like that. So it worked out in that aspect for them as well. So they'll be there and get to see me suited up for you know, my first start this season. So I'm looking forward to it. It'll be a good experience, and you know, just working toward getting a W.
Quentin Dormandy joining us here on the Blitz on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star. Quentin, I think about your journey, and you know, going back to when you were playing high school up in Bernie and the numbers you were putting up going to Tennessee. You have dealt with more injuries and frustration. What is your mindset to keep at trying to play quarterback at a professional level with everything that you've been through throughout your college career and so far in your pro career?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of funny that you bring that up. I mean, it seems like I've just been on a pretty good roller coaster since high school. But I have a good supporting cast around me with my family and friends. So, I'm confident with that, and I know what I can do. It's just a matter of, you know, when I get my opportunity, and it's not necessarily on my timing always and what I want, but I know the good Lord has a plan for me, and you know, this is how He's written it up. Not ideal for you know, Chase to get hurt and me to have to step in that role, and not ideal for me to be the backup, because that's not what I had drawn up, but you know, that's how He had it written. So I'm just looking forward to the opportunity to get back out there and play ball and go have fun. That's the whole goal. I mean, you know, everybody grows up playing this game and having fun, and now, you know, you can somewhat lose sight of that when you get to this level and there's money to be made and things like that. You kind of can get caught up in the revolving door of it all, and I'm just gonna go out there and try to have fun with the guys and come out with a win in the end, and you know, move forward from last week with when we hit a little bit of adversity. So looking forward to getting back out there in front of the home fans for the last time for a few weeks as we go on a little bit of a road trip. So looking forward to it.
You know, Quentin, that's a great attitude. I really do. I mean that sincerely. You know, you going in and being able to be the quarterback of this football team. You know, Wade told us at the very beginning, you know, it's difficult to know what this team's going to be like and how you guys are going to gel coming out of the gate. You guys did. You started 2-0, and as you mentioned, you stumbled a little bit last week. But what has it been like in that locker room between all of you guys and coming together and gelling the way you are and playing the kind of football you're playing right now?
Yeah, I mean, I think we have a good group in the locker room. You know, it's this experience, you know, XFL last year and then this year in the UFL is different than any other, you know, football experience that probably anyone's had. Just, you know, we come in, we have a month to learn a playbook, learn new coaches, learn a scheme, you know, learn new players, gel with people. So it happens really quick. But I think that, you know, as a team, we've come together. We stick behind each other. You know, defense held it together against Memphis a couple of weeks ago for us to, you know, be able to come back this past week. Offense needed to score a few more points, and we couldn't get it done. But, you know, we all have each other's back. We're ready to move forward, ready to put in the work that needs to be put in. So, you know, just ready to move forward and go out and get a win this weekend.
Quentin Dormandy joining us here on the Blitz. And I go back and think about Bernie, and I can't believe you've been out of high school this long. It doesn't feel like that long, but, you know, I remember how you slung it up there playing for your dad there at Bernie. And now, you know, I think about this offense and what we've seen. And then last week, it seemed like so many short passes behind the line of scrimmage. You, Quentin, from what I remember, what you were doing in high school and, you know, following you throughout college, you like to sling it downfield. With you now as the starting quarterback, will we see different plays called that where you are slinging it more downfield, or will it be similar to what we were seeing with Chase and a lot of the swing out passes?
Yeah, first I want to say, you don't have to tell me that I've been out of high school because I feel that too. I'm like, you know, a couple of years ago when I was in high school, wait, hold on. That was like 10 years ago.
Yeah, dude, you're 28, but, man. That's I had to look that up and went, wait, 28? That can't be right. You're like 23.
Oh, I know. I'm getting old. I don't think, you know, no new plays necessarily are going to be called. I mean, I think that any quarterback in any team, you know, obviously it's getting to that kind of point in the season where, you know, some injuries are starting to show up. So you kind of have to, you know, you want to play to the strengths of your players and what you got that week and who's healthy and who's not and that kind of thing. You know, and that kind of plays into the quarterback position. You know, Chase, you know, has his skill set. I have mine. I think, you know, obviously I would love to throw the ball downfield every play. And I do think that that's a strong suit of mine is downfield accuracy. But, at the same time, I want to distribute to the playmakers. And if I can't get a deep shot, then I'm not just going to throw it. But, I'd like to say, yeah, you're going to see some more, downfield stuff, but, you know, we'll see when we get into this, to the flow of the game and kind of see what we're getting defensively from them. And that'll dictate where I'm throwing the ball. So I'm not locked into anything right now. Just going to take what the defense gives me. But, if shots do present themselves, I'm definitely going to let it fly for sure.
Quentin, I've got to ask you because obviously Wade Phillips, I mean, you know who he is, obviously, he's a legend of the game, been around a long time. What's it like playing for a guy like that?
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, he obviously has a ton of experience and a ton of knowledge. So there's little things that, you know, you pick up on, you know, even just going through training camp, things of why he does certain things or why he's thinking certain things. And then obviously, as far as, you know, practice goes and things like that, he obviously is defensive coach. So, you know, he's got his input as far as what they're running defensively. And, you know, I think that makes us a better offense going against, you know, a defense that's coached by, you know, Coach Reed and, you know, Coach Wade, obviously, being a legend. So, I think that's made us kind of the offense we are today. And then just looking to build on that, going into this weekend for sure.
Quentin Dormandy, quarterback of the San Antonio Brahmas, takes over as the starting quarterback this week as they get ready to play Michigan 6 o'clock in the Alamo Dome on Saturday night. Now, Quentin, the Brahmas are unveiling their new Fiesta medals, and there's a ticket package where you can buy tickets and get a Fiesta medal. Being a Bernie kid, do you have to explain to your teammates what the hell a Fiesta medal is?
I didn't know about the deal, but I don't think many people are gonna catch on to any of that. And it's like I said, it's been a while since I've been down there, so it's something that's not necessarily even ringing a bell with me to start with. So
all right, Fiesta medals. Not really. You haven't been gone that long. You remember Fiesta and all little medals everybody gets? Cascarones, where they smash the egg with the confetti in them on your head. Although at 6'5", that probably didn't happen to you very often when you were at Bernie, right?
It did not happen to me a whole lot. But you're bringing back old memories for sure.
Well, you go back to Bernie. Do you even recognize that city? I mean, honestly, it's grown like crazy.
Yeah. Well, you know, my dad's a high school coach down here. So, that's why we moved to Bernie. He was the head football coach at Bernie High School. So, when I was there, it was, basically the edge of the hill country. That's, there was not much there. And, even when I went back a couple of years later in college, I could tell that it was getting ready to explode. And I haven't been back over there, since my dad left when I was in college. So I've heard tons of stories. I know, my favorite restaurants and stuff are still there, but I'm sure there's a lot more now. I'm sure I would not recognize it.
Yeah, the explosion would happen. You would actually probably have to use GPS to get around Bernie if it's been a while since you've been up there, for sure. Well, Quentin, hopefully a lot of those old fans of yours at Bernie are going to make their way to the Alamo Dome. You mentioned your family's coming into town for the game, your first start for the San Antonio Brahmas. Man, I've been following your journey since high school and, at Tennessee and then, Houston, Central Michigan. What would you play in Canada too? I mean, just stay healthy and get it done, man. Throw a bunch of touchdowns, light up the scoreboard and, kind of get back into where you want to be. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt. I appreciate you guys supporting us and that, and appreciate you letting me come on the show today. We're going to go out there and get a dub on Saturday.
So. There you go. Appreciate it, man. Good luck on that Saturday. Quentin Dormandy, the new starting quarterback of the San Antonio Brahmas, as he joins us, as all our guests do, on the Buyers Barricades guest line, where they provide traffic control, rental, and sales for San Antonio and beyond online at buyersbarricades.com. The backup quarterback's always the most popular guy.
Well, absolutely. And now he's not the backup quarterback, though.
And not that I was going to say this to him, but the fans that were around me in the Alamo Dome on Saturday with all these swing passes is put in Quentin. Let's see what he can do. And you always get that.
Sure.
And it's like you talk to, a high school coach's wife. A lot of times they like to sit by themselves or around a very secure group of people because of all the, because that happens everywhere you go. At one point I think he had, I'd have to look up the first half stats, but it averaged about like 2 yards of completion.
Oh, wow.
I don't expect Dormandy to have that downfield passes, but a lot of that is what the defense does. You look at the numbers Garber was putting up. He was one of the league leaders, but Sunday it was, tough.
Wasn't a good day for him, to say the least.
And then find out he got hurt in the third quarter and he stayed in. It's interesting. We'll talk about some of that with Wade tomorrow.
Absolutely.
With Wade Phillips joining us Wednesdays with Wade. But it'll be interesting to see what Quentin will do. And again,
best of luck to him, man.
Injury everywhere he's been.
Yeah.
This injury, that injury. All right, you're hurt. You're replaced. And he's moving on, chasing football. I didn't realize the kid was 28.
I'm glad he's still playing. He wants to play football. He's still out there, competitive. He's good enough, and happy for him that he's out there playing. I remember him very well. He was quite the high school football player, to say the least.
He was a stud.
Yeah.
And look, he was going to Tennessee. Yeah. And we all thought, and he played some at Tennessee.
Yeah, he did. Sure
until
did.
He got hurt.
Yeah.
And then went to Houston. Yeah. And then he got hurt. And he went to Central Michigan, and He got hurt. He was in, I think, Montreal or wherever. And yeah, but
dude, I admire that. You played Canadian football.
You're chasing football as opposed to getting a real job. I mean, you know, and I don't know what he's going to do, coach or do whatever. I mean, you know, he's a son of a coach. You kind of expect him to go into coaching, but he's chasing football until it's not there.
Absolutely. And why not? If he's enjoying it, why not?
You
stick
see
around?
A lot of guys that do that. You never know if he has some good showings, especially now with NFL teams keeping three active quarterbacks.
Sure.
You know, and, yeah. And look, and you know, that let's hold a clipboard paycheck from the NFL would be pretty damn good.
Not bad.
And
not
you, bad you at just all. Never know. But come on, dude. He doesn't remember Fiesta medals.
Well, it's been 10 years. You know, I don't know. Not everybody's a big Fiesta person.
But still, when you're in high school, I mean, I know that, you know, in Bernie, it's I mean, still, you got to know what a Fiesta medal is.
Well, okay. If I grew up in Bernie, went Bernie High School at the time, a lot to do out in Bernie.
Yeah, there is. And you know what all those high school kids do? They still go to Nyosa. They still go to Oyster Bay.
Dude, I don't know.
They still go.
I'm not going to hold that against him. That,
I mean, does Bernie not have any official Fiesta events?
I'm sure
they're uppity, but, you know,
sure
it's like the
something.
Ones in Alamo Heights, right?
Of course.
I mean, you know.
Taste of the North Side.
6'5", nobody broke an egg over his head.
Of course not. I wouldn't have.
No.
You might have broke one on your face.
Well, the only way you're going to, you know, if he's sitting down, you might get him with an egg.
Yeah.
But he doesn't remember
Fiesta
medals.
Do that. You like Coscarones?
No.
No. Especially me, man. They're in there for like 3 months.
Well, I can imagine. I mean, you know, there's nothing where like 2 weeks later and you're Dude, taking a shower and there's some
exactly.
confetti that hits the floor. Like, where's that been?
Exactly.
Where has that been?
Dude.
You know, and now that you have said that, Thursday when we're broadcasting live at Taste of the North Side, everybody has permission to get Joe with an egg.
Yeah, well, I mean.
Not me,
sure.
Joe.
Yeah.
Joe.
Well, you're a little easier to find. I mean, you got a target.
Well, I've got a target and I'm a tall 5'7".
Exactly.
You know,
perfect size.
Absolutely.
Bam.
I don't mind them, especially if you're outside.
Yeah.
But
I mean, you know, it's one of those things you got to deal with once a year.
Dude, your hair doesn't move when somebody does that to you.
I'm not worried about it moving. It's a little confetti stays in there and gets lost. It's like, woo.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. 3 weeks later, you take a shower. We're like, where's that one been hiding?
Exactly.
How am I still having confetti show up?
All over the place.
All over the place. Crazy. Brahma, Saturday against Michigan. For those that want their Fiesta medals, they have ticket packages. Best way to do that is through their social media channels. Click the link and you can get those.
Yeah, a lot of people really like that. I mean, they collect a bunch of them.
Fiesta medals are a big deal.
Big deal.
They're a big deal.
Yeah. Alexandra wants ours.
We don't have one. No, we don't. I might have one on my desk from like 2013,
well,
2014.
Pledge has one from 20 years ago, I think. Something like that.
Not from this station.
Oh,
this station's not 20 years old.
From somewhere else.
Pledge, the station started in 2008.
Well, it's not the station medal.
Well,
it's another medal.
Oh, he's got a 20-year-old medal. Or he's got a medal from 2020.
2020.
No, that was no. Our station medals. I think it was 2014, 2015. Yeah. We did them when Datwin was working here.
Well, Ken's always has one. They've got one, a new one every year. And I used to get asked about that all the time. Hey, can you get me a medal?
Yeah.
And I'd take some down to the AT&T Center, pass them out.
2017.
All right. Are you keeping that or are you giving that to Alexandra?
I think Alexandra needs it.
I mean, what logo is on that? That's when we were just on, what, 1250 and 94.5 or just 1250?
This has 94.5 too.
Yeah. All right.
Wow.
See, there you go. 2017. Been a while.
Cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's a collector's edition.
Sure.
I guess $7 on eBay for that one.
$7? Yeah.
Maybe.
Uh-huh.
Maybe.
Yeah,
maybe $12.50.
Got it.
Oh, dude.
You think somebody would pay $12.50 for that?
I don't know. If anybody's got $12.50 and you want Pledge's Fiesta medal, I'll take your money and Pledge will give you the medal.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great idea, Jim.
That is a great idea.
What are you gonna give? What are you gonna buy for $12.50?
I can buy a chicken on a stick and half a beer.
For $12.50? That beer maybe will cost you $12.50.
What is that?
That's it.
I can't see. Is that old energy 90?
That's energy 94.1.
Wow.
Yeah, see, that's see that one there, $15. I'm selling them right now. We're going to auction them off for good causes.
That's some sad news. Whitey Herzog died. Remember Whitey Herzog? Yeah,
absolutely.
He lived a good, I mean, he was 91. As a Cardinal fan, I'd have to say he.
Did you just see that on Twitter? Because I read that this morning.
Well, I did too, but okay. I forgot about it, and I was reminded they just flashed it up there. Uh-huh. Yeah. No, I got a text early this morning from my brother.
Yeah.
And I was very sad. He used to have a barbecue place there in St. Louis, downtown St. Louis. Delicious ribs. We'd go there every time we went to St. Louis.
Mm-hmm.
It was good.
Were they actually good, or you were just there because it was? Herzog's
well, no, they
place.
Were actually good.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, they were really good.
All right.
It's called Whitey Herzog's. It was right by the old ballpark.
Of course.
The old one. Yes, the old Busch Stadium. Yeah.
He knows how to make money.
Of course.
Absolutely. Lived a hell of a life.
He did.
Got you guys a World Series.
Absolutely. We've got a few of those.
You do?
Yeah.
None recent, but you.
Well, you've got what, 2011?
Yeah, that's not recent.
That was against the Texas Rangers.
It was.
Sure was.
We've got the Rangers have one since then. Uh-huh. The Astros have a couple. Uh-huh. And Albert Pujols' ball still hasn't landed.
It still hasn't landed.
It still hasn't landed. And Brad Lidge is still looking for
you
it.
You think Lidge has nightmares?
Yes. Yes. Yes, he does.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's talk about the NBA play-in tournament that is kicking off tonight. Plus, we'll talk some Cowboys with Shireen Williams at 5:15 here on The Blitz. Guys, if you're dealing with a lack of energy, motivation, maybe low libido, those could all be symptoms caused by low T levels. Your testosterone levels start to decline in your 30s. So if you're feeling that lack of energy and drive, you need to get your levels tested. Best place to do that is at Synergenics. They've got locations all over San Antonio, and their medical providers exclusively specialize in customized testosterone treatment, and they make it quick and easy to get your levels checked. And at Synergenics, you will get your results back at your first visit because they have that on-site lab. So make your appointment now to go get tested. FixMyLowT.com is the website. Go to the website, book your appointment, go get tested. If you need it, you will get customized care from testosterone specialists. Take that first step now to get tested. Get your life back. FixMyLowT.com is the website. FixMyLowT.com.
Taking you home with The Blitz. Afternoons 2 to 6, KTFM Floresville. And everywhere at sasportstar.com.
Hey, it's Rob Thompson here for Prize Picks. It's America's number one sports fantasy act. 3 million players? Yes, I'm a member. You should be too. Download it now and remember the code Alamo, and you can get a deposit match of up to $100. Basketball is balling, baby. Football is coming. Baseball is swinging. It is time to go to Prize Picks because you put your fantasy knowledge into action. You know more. You know you're less. You know who's better or not. You know what's going on. You're a fantasy player. Put that knowledge to work. I have, along with so many others. And right now, remember the code Alamo, and you can get $100. Deposit match right now. Go download Prize Picks. We love watching Connor McDavid, Jude Bellingham, LeBron James. They are playing go more or less. It's so easy to do, and now's the time to go. You know when it's more, you know when it's less, and when you pair them together, you can win big, big bucks, up to 100 times your money. More, less, Prize Picks, Alamo. Go there.
Wesley Financial Group is not a law firm.
Are you one of the nearly 10 million families that own a timeshare? Unfortunately, many families stuck in timeshares have learned the dark side of ownership as their timeshare ends up being nothing like they were promised. I'm Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group. If you were lied to when buying a timeshare, you're going to need help. I know this because I once worked as a timeshare salesman, but quit the business and made it my personal mission to help folks get rid of bad timeshares. That's why I put together a timeshare exit information kit to help you understand how the timeshare industry works and your options for cancellation. Over 30,000 families have trusted us to get rid of their timeshares. Many started out by simply calling us for the free information kit and are now timeshare free.
To get your free information kit, call Wesley Financial now. Call 800-837-1919. That's 800-837-1919. 800-837-1919.
Stirring fiber, exercising, frequent trips to the store for more laxatives and fiber. Sounds like your constipation with belly pain is a lot to manage. But if your symptoms that keep coming back are signs of irritable bowel syndrome with constipation or IBS-C, ask your doctor how Linzess can help you get ahead of it. Linzess linaclotide is a prescription medicine that treats IBS-C in adults. It's not a laxative. It's a once-daily pill that helps you get ahead of your symptoms. It's proven to help you have more frequent and complete bowel movements and helps relieve overall abdominal symptoms, belly pain, discomfort, and bloating. These symptoms were studied in combination, not individually. Do not give Linzess to children less than 2. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stools. The most common side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas, stomach area pain, and swelling. Learn more at Linzess.com or call 1-800-LINZESS.
Don't let pain keep you from doing the things you love. I'm Dr. Jason Garrett from Erosti. At Erosti, we fix pain fast. Whether you've been living with chronic and nagging pain for years, or if you've recently experienced an injury, our goal is to get you out of pain as quickly as possible. Erosti is completely natural and non-invasive. Plus, Erosti accepts most insurance plans. There's a location near you. Visit Erosti.com. That's A-I-R-R-O-S-T-I.com. Erosti, we fix pain fast.
Hi, I'm attorney Steve Behnke. If you've made the decision to divorce, you need an experienced attorney who can help. I've helped many people get through divorce, custody, child support, and alimony problems. Call me. I'm attorney Steve Behnke.
210-DIVORCE or go to BehnkeLaw.com.
Twin Peaks is the best in the game. Here, the scenic views stick around after the sun sets, and your favorite cocktails keep you company long after overtime. Where else can you unwind with bourbon and late-night bites? Only at Twin Peaks, the number one sports bar.
Cowboys are on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. San Antonio's Sports Center.
Well, the Texas Rangers had a tough afternoon this afternoon. They lose to the Detroit Tigers by a score of 4-2. Astros continue their series with the Atlanta Braves tonight. By the way, the Astros called up former first-round pick and Alamo Heights pitcher Forrest Whitley. He will be available out of the bullpen, we're told. First pitch is set for 7:10 tonight from Minute Maid Park. Missions are out in Corpus Christi, taking on the Hooks.
Joe Reinagle.
That's the third time in 7 seasons the San Antonio Spurs are the NBA champions.
Jason Minnitz.
They go back to Big Day as Super Bowl champions. Dallas 52, Buffalo 17.
It's the Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. He's Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minnitz.
6:35's first pitch in Corpus Christi. By the way,
you wanted to finish that sentence before you got the hook. As
I got
they
the hook.
Play the hooks. You know, it's kind of cool. Forrest Whitley getting a chance.
Yeah, that's great.
You know, you think about
An injury prone guy that's had rough luck with injuries. That's for sure.
You know, and the kind of talent that gets produced here in San Antonio.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
I mean, you know, Forrest Whitley from Alamo Heights talking to Quentin Dormandy earlier today. Going to get the start this week for the San Antonio Brahmas at quarterback. And earlier in the show, we saw Max DiDomenico, who used to play at Clemens, was quarterback for the Buffaloes, is at Army. He's at West Point. He was named a team captain for Army football for 2024, which is incredible. At the end of spring ball, Jeff Monken, their coach, named Max DiDomenico one of the 4 team captains. And I tweeted that, and Scott Lenhoff, who's now the AD over there, quote tweeted me and said, huge honor for Max. The second Clemens Buffalo alum to be named as a captain at a service academy in recent years. Billy Honecker was named captain at Navy in 2020.
Wow.
Which is true, and I remember that. But it gets me to thinking. You talk about talent and character that they're producing there at Clemens. How many high schools do you think in this country can say that they have developed 2 captains for a service academy team?
I couldn't tell you, but I would imagine
there can't
not
be,
many.
There can't be many.
I wouldn't think so.
I mean, there's a lot of schools that have sent a lot of guys to the service academies.
No doubt.
But for those guys to be captains of those respective teams, alumni from one school, that number's got to be pretty small.
Well, I tell you what, you know, Clemens High School goes back a long way, even before Steele was out there. Coach Linhoff, Scott's dad, was and his Scott's mom. Oh my gosh,
with the pies.
Oh, every time we go out there, we were eating pie, and it was they're just great people, and so congrats to the entire school district out there, but certainly Clements High School. Then you got Frank Harris coming out of there, another character guy.
Absolutely.
And just a lot of character folks coming out of there. And a lot of that credit goes to the Linhoff family, I'm telling you.
Well, I mean, you think about Robert Linhoff all those years, and then when Scott was coaching, and I was a little surprised he moved into the AD role as early as he did with all the success that he had at
I know why he did it.
Well, we all do, but yes. it's just cool that happens.
Yes.
Right?
No, it's a great honor, not only for the two players that you're talking about, but for that school and that school district. It's great.
Well, and I look around, the academies recruit San Antonio extremely well.
Yes.
You look at, Gutierrez was at Jay this year as their quarterback. He's going to Navy next year. Taft has had a bunch. I mean, they're just, I'm a guy that loves watching Service Academy football go Navy. But I watch them all, and it is very cool for Max to have known him as long as I have, and then to see him get named captain, knowing how hard he's worked to get there and everything that he does. It's just such a cool honor. And then to think, I forgot about Billy being captain at Navy just a couple of years ago. Not many high schools could probably claim that.
I'll tell you what, I don't think people understand the honor that is and how difficult it is to be named captain. It's not just something that, you're next in line. I mean, you have to show that kind of character to do that, and leadership, and Max certainly does that.
Being a captain at a service academy, very different than being at UTSA, and every program has their traditions, whether you're a single digit number at UTSA or you're at a Texas A&M or whatever. So it's got to be rare, because there's only four every year, and for one high school to produce two in recent years,
that's
impressive.
Pretty cool.
That's cool stuff. We'll talk with Shireen Williams coming up in a few minutes about the Cowboys and some things that Stephen Jones had to say. Talk some NBA playoffs as well, but a developing story out of Miami with the Miami Dolphins. According to Jeff Darlington at ESPN, the Dolphins and Tua are getting into some pretty serious contract talks.
They are.
I find that interesting just from the timing of it. It kind of feels like the NFL world is on hold right now, unless you're dealing with the draft. So why now for Tua? Because he's in the same boat as Dak Prescott.
Why not?
He could play this year and become a free agent, unrestricted free agent. So I do find it interesting that they're talking contract a week before the draft.
Get it done, right? I mean, if he's your guy, get it done. And that's apparently what they're doing. I got to admit, I was dead wrong with Tua. I really thought this guy was going to be a bust in the NFL, and he has proven that he's not. I mean, he's been a very serviceable quarterback. I wouldn't say he's a star, but he's going to get paid like one here pretty soon.
Well, and if you're the Cowboys, if Tua gets that deal done, does he reset the market?
No, Tua's not going to reset the market. I don't care if he's next. He's not going to.
All right.
He'll make in the neighborhood of 52 to 55 million bucks a year.
Okay.
He's not going to reset the market.
You don't think he's going to top Joe Burrow by 3%?
Perhaps.
All right. So
I don't care who's next. I think that is a flawed system in the NFL.
It's a flawed system.
Well, it is, and they need to change it, because it's ruining it for everybody else.
But again, though, if Tua does reset the market and he gets more than Joe Burrow, and again, the total contract versus the guaranteed parts of it, all of that stuff you look at, does that not make Dak's contract more expensive now?
Well, sure it will.
Right?
It will.
And again, this is the problem that so many have with Jerry waiting, and it costs you more in the end.
Well, Yeah, I just have a real issue with that because guys, I mean, like Justin Herbert is another example. Mm-hmm. You know why he has is making the money that he's making is ridiculous to me. I mean, honestly, he's done nothing. I could even see a Jalen Hurts. At least he's been to a Super Bowl. You know, Burrow's been to a Super Bowl. It's a flawed system, and I wish it would change, because just because somebody is next doesn't mean that they deserve it. I mean, it's true.
It is based on future performance.
Well,
you're banking on that it's going to work.
Well, I'm not.
That's what they're doing. Well, we'll talk about it coming up with Shireen Williams from Pro Football Talk here on The Blitz. If you're dealing with any issues at your house with your plumbing or your AC, you know there is one company to call, and that is Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heating, and AC. 210-651-5899. At Quarter Moon, they are full service. Big job, small job, residential, or commercial. Their service trucks are fully stocked, and they have all the equipment needed for any job. No commission. Sales reps, they'll provide estimates and second opinions, and they have a great experienced staff that has earned an A-plus ranking with the Better Business Bureau. And at Quarter Moon, they are green certified. If you do know you need a new AC, now's the time to buy from Quarter Moon, because all 14 SEER up to 3-ton AC systems are just $69.99 installed for a limited time. So call Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heating, and AC. 210-651-5899, 651-5899, or online at quartermoonplumbing.com.
It's the 2024 NFL Draft on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
We're the 24th pick. The Dallas Cowboys select.
April 25th, 26th, and 27th. Join 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star for this year's NFL Draft. Live from Detroit.
I love the tenacity and the aggression with which he plays. He is a mauler.
Who do the Cowboys and Texans pick? Does Jerry make a splash? Who goes number one? And who's the next Mr. Irrelevant?
The Houston Texans select C.J. Stroud.
You don't ever want to pass on the guy you ought to be taking there, but still be position select.
I thought Sauce Gardner would be the first corner, but you go back to 2019, and that version of Derek Stingley is as good as anybody in this entire draft class.
Find out right here on your exclusive home for the NFL Draft. 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Pro San Antonio football returns to the Alamo Dome this Saturday night as the San Antonio Brahmas play host to the Michigan Panthers. Peck the dome for a 6 p.m. kickoff. Follow the Brahmas social channels for a link to get your Brahmas Fiesta medal with your tickets. Experience the excitement. Buy your tickets now at theufl.com. Come watch Coach Wade Phillips lead the Brahmas to take on the Michigan Panthers Saturday night at 6 in the dome. Get your tickets now at theufl.com. Vamos Brahmas!
Hi, my name's Jason Thompson. I've lived in San Antonio for more than 50 years. Went to grade school, high school, and graduated from law school right here. San Antonians have trusted me as their attorney after serious injury and fatality collision since 1994. My website is alawyerforus.com. Why a lawyer for us? Well, after several years of practice, I watched as insurance companies created their own law firms solely to defend against auto claims. Today, there are very few insurance companies that do not have their own captive law firm filled with attorneys whose job is to minimize what the insurance company has to pay on an auto claim. If you or a family member is injured in a traffic collision, you will need your own attorney. Just remember alawyerforus.com. For many lawyers you see on billboards, your case will be handled by a non-lawyer or a staff lawyer. If you call me, Jason Thompson, I will be the lawyer you speak with. The initial consultation is always free. If you or a family member needs an experienced attorney, an attorney you can trust, I want you to call me, Jason Thompson. My number is 900-0400. That's 210-900-0400 or alawyerforus.com.
If you're a man and you live in San Antonio or the surrounding areas, you need to pay close attention to what I'm about to say. Are you having issues rising to the occasion? Do you constantly worry about whether or not you can perform? Have you completely stopped having adult time? Is it something you just don't talk about? Guys, we have a solution. Mojo, the 100% guaranteed male enhancement pill that's fast, effective, and was designed to reignite passion, performance, and confidence in the bedroom.
Yeah.
Be ready at a moment's notice with the Mojo Male Enhancement Pill from Pure Line Nutrition. And for those of you who have used Mojo, check out Mojo Endura Max.
Touchdown!
a new formula that improves the potency and effectiveness of Mojo. Get fast results, last longer, and be the man she'll never forget. Mojo and Mojo Enduramax, 100% natural male enhancement formulas only available at Pure Line Nutrition. Call now, 210-494-2210. That's 210-494-2210. Or visit us online at thepureline.com.
Lowe's knows pros need the right tools for every job. That's why we sell the largest in-store selection of Klein tools anywhere. Find new items like the self-leveling green laser level for just $159.98. Plus, shop the Connect pass-through socket set for $49.98, which you can only find at Lowe's. Shop Klein tools in-store and online today, because Lowe's knows tools. Lowe's knows pros.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. 120,000 miles of night drives, daily commutes, and who knows how many.
Are we there yet?
Through countless fixes, elbow grease, and a new radiator, you kept your ride alive. With eBay Motors, you have over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob Thompson and RJ Ochoa.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, the first play-in night is done. Are we headed toward an epic confrontation on Friday night? We'll look forward to the games in the East as well. The Cowboys, they're on the clock. Are they going to do something crazy? Is Xavier coming to the Cowboys? We'll look at another mock draft and figure out where they're going. Now back to the Blitz. Boys, I got the memo. We got to start cleaning this place up. Looks like we're going to do a little remodeling. Will you grab your stuff and put it in a box?
Yeah, but it's all of Rob's stuff in studio that needs to go. That's the funny thing.
I don't have any stuff here.
Yeah, exactly. It is the Blitz here on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star. He is Joe Reinagle. I'm Jason Minix. Fresh off a trip to the Masters, Shereen Williams from Pro Football Talk joining us here on the Buyers Barricades at Guest Line. Shereen, before we get into Cowboy Talk, how was the Masters experience?
Oh, man, it was incredible. My top three all time. I think the Olympics, I've been to seven of those, are number one. Super Bowl, I've been to 29 of those, are number two. And I think Olympics, I mean, the Masters along with Wimbledon are tied for third. It was just an unbelievable experience. The Disneyland of golf, I think, and just incredible. Even if you're not a golfer or a golf fan, I think it's well worth a trip for you to go if you get the opportunity, because it's just beautiful. It's hard to describe what the experience is like, but it's incredible.
Yeah, I've always heard that with people that have gone, Shereen, that it's just you're just looking around like you can't believe what you're seeing. And it's just incredible. I can't wait. It's certainly on the bucket list for sure. No question about it. All right, Shereen, I've got to ask you a question. Tua is apparently negotiating a contract with the Miami Dolphins. I look at Tua. He's good, serviceable quarterback. And, of course, it always comes back to the Cowboys and Dak Prescott. But I'm a little bit annoyed that the system in the NFL right now is, well, he's next. So he's going to reset the market. It clearly doesn't deserve to reset the market. Do you think that needs to change? And do you think it ever will?
I don't know if it needs to change or not. That's not up to me. So I don't honestly have an opinion on that. It is what it is, as players like to say, and that's just what happens. You know, you're only worth what somebody pays you. And if they want to pay you that much, don't blame the player. I mean, don't blame Tua that they want to reset the market for him. I mean, if they offered it to any of us, we're going to accept it. So, you know, always cringe when fans side with the billionaires over the millionaires. Why aren't you siding with the owners? Players should want to get everything they can possibly get. And as Marcus Lawrence said, it's not my responsibility to deal with the salary cap. And it's not. The teams have to figure out a way to make it work underneath the salary cap. That's incumbent on them, not on the player. So, you know, I have no problem with players getting what they can get. Now, does he deserve to reset the market? Absolutely not. Like, he's not one of the top five quarterbacks in the NFL. There's no question about that. I mean, I don't think anybody would call him one of the top five quarterbacks in the NFL. And you might be hard-pressed to call him one of the top 10 quarterbacks in the NFL. But I tell you what, when they get that contract done, it's going to look great a year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now, 4 years from now. If he can play like they think he can play, that contract is going to get better and better and better and better. And that's what the Cowboys should have done with Dak Prescott. They didn't want to pay the money. It took them 2 years to get him his second contract. They overpaid because they waited. And because they waited, they're now in the situation they're in today. Sooner than later, get the contract done. And in the long term, if you believe in that player and he's as good as you think he is, it's going to be a great contract for you eventually. If he's not, then yes, it's going to be a terrible contract. You better be sure, I guess is what I'm saying, when you give him that contract.
You know, and I think about Jerry waiting and it costs him money. I look at the Eagles. Yeah. They are known to pay guys early, like they did this week with Smith. But by doing that, Smith will also be back at the negotiating table a little bit sooner. So it is a different philosophy. But if you're Dak and you're watching SportsCenter and you see the Jeff Darlington report that they're negotiating, well, all right, let's see what Tua gets, because I'm going to get more than that guy. You always want to, you know, be the last, like CeeDee Lamb. Let Justin Jefferson get his deal before you get yours, right? But ultimately, Jerry waiting, it's going to cost him more money again with Dak Prescott, and it feels like it didn't really have to.
Correct. And I'll go back to what you were talking about with the Eagles. That used to be the Cowboys' philosophy. Recently, Tyron Smith, they got a great deal with Tyron Smith. I mean, an unbelievable deal with Tyron Smith, and they did that deal early. Zach Martin, I think, got his early. You know, they've done it with several players. They gave him their second contract. They did it with Zeke, but only because Zeke held out. And I think that's what's going to happen with CeeDee Lamb. I don't think you're going to see CeeDee Lamb until he gets a new contract. And if that happens into the season, then that happens, he's not going to be there. I think that's absolutely what you're going to see with CeeDee Lamb. I think he's going to force their hand because he knows that's the only way he's going to get his money before next year, before the offseason. Because Cowboys are content to let him play on the fifth-year option, knowing that they have the franchise tag in their back pocket if they need it for next year. So I think he's going to push that issue just like Ezekiel Elliott pushed that issue. But I can't remember what the beginning of your question was, and I know I went off tangent there. But I agree with you. They've got to get Dak done. And, you know, it doesn't look like they're going to get it done like now, but they need to get it done, not for – obviously free agency is passed. That's when you really needed to get it done, to have room for free agency, room to sign CeeDee Lamb, all those things. But they really do need to get this contract done sooner than later. The price is only going to go up as these quarterbacks continue to sign. If Tua gets $50 million, then Cowboys are going to have to pay more for Dak Prescott. He's done more than Tua has. He can just put that in front of the Cowboys and go, here you go. I was, you know, second team all pro, and I was second in MVP voting. And if you want to keep me, here's what the price is. So they really do need to get that contract done sooner than later.
You know, Shireen, a lot of question marks and a lot of holes to fill, at least we think. You listen to Steven today, and it almost seems like he loves his offensive line and some of the players that they've developed and that are there. And that, you know, there's a new report today. They may go wide receiver with the number one pick. That was a mock draft.
Yeah, Schrager mock draft with Xavier Worthy.
Yeah, not sure, you know, if that's – but I know the Cowboys like to develop players, and I know they think that – the players that they develop are the next, and maybe they are. But do you think they'd be rolling the dice if they didn't go offensive line and fill some of these holes with some top draft picks?
Absolutely, 100%, no question about it. I mean, they're in trouble if they can't improve that offensive line through the draft. I don't think there's any ifs, ands, and buts about that. I think that's absolutely surefire true. And I think, you know, if that were to happen, I think you're going to see Tyler Smith slide outside the left tackle. But, you know, there's questions about really how good Terrence Steele is. You still need a center. Who's going to be your center? I don't know that anybody on that roster is going to be really who you want him to be. And, you know, Zach Martin has lost a step. So he's still really good. Don't get me wrong. And I love Zach. He's still really good. But he's not as good as he was 2 years ago or 3 years ago or 4 years ago when he was consistently all pro and consistently. I would say I still rank him as one of the best of all time, But I don't think when you start looking at the guards that he is that much more dominant at right guard than other guys in the league. He's still very good, but you can tell he's not as good as what he was. I think the injuries have taken a toll. So all that to say, they need help really at every single one of those positions. Aside from Tyler Smith, wherever you're going to play him, I think he's the one surefire starter who you can count on, who's probably going to make a Pro Bowl wherever you put him next year, sort of like Larry Allen was. But I think if they neglect that offensive line, I think they're in a little bit of trouble. I think Dak's in a little bit of trouble. I think the run game's in a little bit of trouble. Look, if you don't have time in this league, they don't have very much time as it is, but if you don't have a good offensive line to give you as much time as possible, you're in trouble. And so that's what I see happening with the Cowboys. If they don't draft linemen early and often, I just think it's going to be bad for the Cowboys. You know, Bill Parcells is the one that first taught me. He taught me a lot about football, but that you build in the lines. If you have a good offensive line and a good defensive line, you're going to have a good football team. We know the Cowboys are going to have a good defensive line. Are they going to have a good offensive line? I don't think so unless they use some draft picks on offensive linemen and get some help in there.
Shereen Williams from Pro Football Talk joining us here on The Blitz. Now, staying with this and follow me as I try to piece a good question together here, Shereen, which, you know, can be difficult at times. I want the Cowboys to draft an offensive lineman. That's what I want. Yeah. Now,
agreed.
For the exact same reasons you just said. And when I see somebody like Peter Schrager have Xavier Worthy in a mock draft, and there's only a couple people that put out that I go, all right, that could be interesting. But I go, okay, what is Schrager hearing that he's got Xavier Worthy? Could it be, and if this is the philosophy, I'm not saying I would agree with it, but could wide receivers be going the way of running backs where Jerry might be saying, CD, I love you, but I'm not going to pay you $30 million. I'll just draft another one because the draft is full of great wide receivers. And they take a wide receiver like Xavier Worthy and CD Lamb, play on your fifth year option, and then we're going to let you walk because we've got your replacement already drafted.
They did that with Amari Cooper. It's entirely possible that's the case. They drafted CeeDee Lamb when they already had a number one receiver in Amari Cooper, and one of the big mistakes they made. And they don't make a ton, I'll say that. Will McClay is very, very good at his job, but they made a huge mistake trading Amari Cooper for a fifth-round draft pick. Huge mistake. They didn't want to pay him $20 million. I would hope they wouldn't make that same mistake with CeeDee Lamb, but that absolutely could play out just as you said. Come and play or don't play. We don't care. We've got your replacement here. You're playing on the fifth-year option. Guess what? If you don't come in and hit whatever the date is that he has to come in and play, which is the middle of the season, to get his accrued season, then we own your rights next year. So, you know, it's kind of up to you whether you want to come in and play or not and take the $17 million or not. You know, we have your replacement here, and we're good with that. So I absolutely could see that happening because they've done it once before. And look, it's really hard to pay a ton of money to a receiver and a quarterback with what receivers contracts, the top receivers, their contracts are going $30 million. And the quarterbacks now are at 50 and above. So think about that. That's $80 million right there of your cap tied up in a quarterback and a receiver. And if I've got to pick, I'm sorry, if I've got to pick CeeDee Lamb or Dak Prescott, you would like to think they can work both of them under the cap, but that's a lot of money. If they can't, then Dak Prescott should be your priority, and you should get a receiver, and you should start rebuilding at that position and go with a younger player if that's what you think you have to do in order to pay your quarterback and guess what, your edge rusher, because they're not going to let Micah Parsons go anywhere. And teams do think that they can get receivers, and it doesn't necessarily have to be in the first round. You look at Puka Nacua last year. There's so many examples of receivers who teams find in the second, third, fourth, fifth round who come in and are really good right away. So that may be their thinking. 100% that may be their thinking. They haven't had, according to Calvin Watkins of Dallas Morning News 4 days ago, they have had no substantial talks with CeeDee Lamb. So it doesn't even seem like they're trying to get these deals done right now.
Well, I find that interesting. And with the Cowboys, you never know, Shereen. But I've got to ask you, you mentioned Micah Parsons, and you don't think they're going to let him get away. When does Micah Parsons start to think about, well, I'd rather have that contract now rather than later, but kind of a Zeke Elliott move, if you will.
I think they can get away with it for one more year. I think he'll come in and he'll be okay for one more year playing under what he's playing. But yeah, if they don't do it by this time next year, I think you're going to see the same thing with Micah Parsons that you're seeing with CeeDee Lamb. I just don't think he's going to show up. And I think he's going to force their hand and say, you know, either you pay me or I'm not playing, period, end of story. It worked for Zeke. So now they think because the Cowboys caved in and gave Zeke that contract, which, by the way, was not a good contract for the Cowboys. They'd been better served just saying, show up or don't show up, we don't care. They would have been better served doing that than what they did with the Ezekiel Elliott contract. So they just face so many tough decisions. I mean, it's not pretty with what the Cowboys are facing. Now, I guess you could say it's a good problem to have that they have three players who are the best at their positions, among the best at their positions, who are going to reset the market at their position. But it is a problem, regardless if you want to call it a good problem or not. It is a problem to try to fit all three of those contracts under your salary cap and put together a really good team with a lot of depth.
That's how they define all in. We're all in with our good problems to have, RPPs.
Yeah.
That's what it is. Shereen Williams from Pro Football Talk. Next week, it is draft week. It's going to be a lot of fun. Appreciate the knowledge, insight, and I imagine you spent a lot of money at the Masters gift shop. I'll keep checking the mail.
About $500. So you're right about that.
$500. That's it. You got off cheap.
Yeah, I think we probably did.
Yeah. Okay. See, you've been to so many events. You know how to work the gift shops there.
Yeah.
You know.
That's right.
That's
go in, get in, and get what you need, and get out.
That's it. I'm not getting anybody nothing. It's all for me. That's what I'm doing. Shereen, always appreciate it. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate it. The great Shereen Williams. Make sure you follow her on Twitter at NFL Shereen. Read her and watch her at Pro Football Talk as she joins us on the Buyers Barricades guest line, where they provide traffic control, rental, and sales for San Antonio and beyond, online at buyersbarricades.com.
Tell you what, I'm in a gambling mood.
All right, you're going to go all in?
All in.
All in.
You can do that.
All right, Jerry.
You can do that at the big blind.
Yeah, I've seen you go all in.
And you can really go all in.
Just like Jerry. That didn't work.
No, it didn't. It didn't. But you know what's good about it? I can do it again, and the results might be a little bit different. Hey, we were out at the big blind last Wednesday, and Wednesday's a great night to go out there because they have their Wednesday 6K. Starts at 6:15. It's a $60 buy-in. You can re-enter for $60 if you need to. Plus, there is free cash play the entire night with a tournament entry, not to mention the fact that you get two free cocktail vouchers with your tournament entry. Wednesday night is a great night at the big blind, but hey, every night's a good night at the big blind. In fact, you go in there tonight and practice a little bit, and you won't miss any of the action, the NBA action, because they have TVs everywhere. Look, the big blind is owned by the same owners of the Roo Pub and the Angry Elephant. So you know everything is top-notch. Everything is first class. The food is fantastic. They have beverages served directly to your table, a full bar, and again, TVs all over the place, so you don't miss any of the action. I've been to a lot of poker houses in San Antonio. None of them come close to comparing to the big blind. It is the premier poker room in San Antonio. If you haven't checked out the big blind, you need to get in there and check it out. And don't forget tomorrow night, the Wednesday 6K, only $60 to get in, and it is a blast. I know, I played last week. Go see them at the big blind. It's right there at 281 and Redland Road.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ.
Wednesday on the Morning Huddle, we look back to the first play-ins. We get more tonight, and also the Spurs draft history. Looks like a 5 pick all the way through an 8. We'll look at the history of the Spurs in that order.
Plus, the NFL draft begins next Thursday night. Who are the Dallas Cowboys going to take in the first round? Who are the Houston Texans going to take when it's all said and done? I might convince Rob to do a mock draft. You don't want to miss it. The Morning Huddle starts at 6.
It's the Morning Huddle with Rob and RJ. Morning 6 to 10 on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
Progressive presents good news, bad news, dumb news, then great news. Good news. Your coworker Kyle said bundling home and auto insurance with Progressive could save you money. Bad news. While saying this, Kyle was eating your clearly labeled lunch. Dumb news. Pizza near work costs $7 a slice, and it tastes like drywall covered in ketchup. Great news.
you decide to see if you could save money bundling at Progressive.com and enjoy more lunches far away from Kyle. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers not available in all states.
Ew, gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
Replace your worn-out brakes and save now on Brake Best Select. Brake Best Select Pro are import direct brake pads and rotors only at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Tyler from Wendy's here. The best part of Wendy's new Cinnabon Pull-Apart is every part. Unlike mornings, which have no good parts, until now. Because with Wendy's new breakfast Cinnabon Pull-Apart, mornings finally don't completely suck. And now that mornings have warm cinnamon sugar rolled dough and ooey gooey frosting, are they the best part of every day? Probably not, but you get the idea. Get to Wendy's today and get the best part in every bite with the new Cinnabon Pull-Apart.
At participating U.S. Wendy's, Cinnabon is a registered trademark of Cinnabon franchisor SPD LLC.
Syntec Premium Full Synthetic Motor Oil is formulated for today's engines. Available only at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Looking for the ultimate hangout spot? Swing by 90 Proof Bar and Grill, where the kitchen stays fired up till midnight, serving up all your game day favorites with daily drink specials. 90 Proof Bar and Grill, corner of Highway 90 and Lucky Ranch. Food, cold drinks, and live sports.
Pork rinds pack a protein punch and are the boldest low-carb snacks out there. Skip the chip and try Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds for that ultimate crunch. And with flavors that will have you craving for more, the time to stock up on Southern Recipe at HEB is now. Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds. Be big, be bold, be adventurous. If you get arrested, get out of jail fast by calling AA Best Bail Bonds, 210-225-2121. Text BAIL to 474747 or online at mybestbailbonds.com. You don't have to call attorneys or anybody else. Don't be forced into a PR bond. If the jail offers you one, make sure you understand the conditions before accepting it. AA Best Bail Bonds, nobody beats their price. They have payment plans. Call 210-225-2121 or mybestbailbonds.com.
License number 149.
Hormones can affect everything. Bad skin, bad hair, low energy, poor sleep, brain fogginess, libido, and weight gain. I'm Dr. Torres at the Institute for Functional Health, and we take a functional approach to your hormone problems. Eating right and exercise will not be beneficial without optimal hormone function. This goes for men and women. We do state-of-the-art testing to get to the root of your hormone issues and help you get well and stay well. I'm Dr. Torres at the Institute for Functional Health. We can help. 210-468-1891.
This is Tony Pollard, and you're listening to The Blitz on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
We're still playing that, huh?
So much hate for Tony Pollard. 1,000-yard running back for the Cowboys.
Ex-Cowboy. Not a Cowboy great. Not a legend. He doesn't get invited to the parties anymore.
Well, he might.
He's not.
They'll bring him back in a couple of years.
Nah.
You know what they do? Going to bring Zeke back.
Well, that could be different.
Why is that different?
I'm talking about the parties. You know, the alumni events. Tony won't get invited.
You never know.
I do.
Well, even if Tony gets invited, he won't know he was invited because he doesn't check his emails or anything else.
His
so
phones. That was one of the damnedest things.
That's crazy.
On Radio Row. Tony Pollard then still with the Cowboys, sort of.
he
told us he wanted to come back.
Yeah,
but he was also going where he was going to get the most money.
And he got a good deal.
And he had no idea that Dan Quinn left the Cowboys to become the head coach of the Washington football team. It was the damnedest thing.
It was crazy.
I
both of us looked at him like, really, dude, is this a prank?
Well, when he found out live, and we asked him the next day, he was like, yeah, I had no clue.
Yeah.
Like, I totally check out. Like, that's how? I mean, part of me wishes there would be times that you could just disconnect like that. But even the group text from your teammates, it's one thing if you don't have Twitter or Instagram and, all right, I'm not going to watch SportsCenter for a week because I'm so devastated by my loss for the Green Bay. But you get to the Super Bowl and you don't know that your defensive coordinator is the head coach of another team.
Yeah, that's a problem.
I mean, at that point, you lie and you fake it. You're like, yeah, I got no really comment on that. You know, he was the defensive coach. I don't know. Are you friends with your teammates? No. You know, Dak's your quarterback, right? Yeah. He had a baby. He did? What?
Good for Tony. I wish I could do that and just unplug.
Well,
that's great. I think it's great that he could do that. He's out spending his $10 million that he earned over the season.
Sure.
He wasn't buying phones with it, but
no,
he was doing something with
it. I mean, and he had an iPhone.
Yeah.
It's not like he had a flip phone.
He's just a different cat.
Yeah.
A little bit of a different guy.
Yeah. No, he's a
Tennessee
Titan.
Not a bad thing.
No.
Not a bad thing.
Did you order a jersey yet?
I haven't. No.
Tennessee Titans Pollard jersey?
Have not.
Do you own a Tennessee Titans jersey?
Vince Young.
As a Titans? Well, you got an Oilers jersey.
Well, it's an Oilers. It's a throwback.
Do you actually own anything with the Titans logo on it?
I have an old Eddie George, just an Academy type jersey. It's not real.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Well, it's a real jersey. It's the knockoff, it's not the expensive.
No. Now, the Vince Young one is, it's real. But it is an Oilers jersey because I think that might have been one of the first times they brought back the old throwbacks.
Yeah.
I don't know. But,
you don't own like a Titans golf shirt?
No.
You don't own like a Titans hat?
No.
A Titans t-shirt.
You got to understand. Look, Titans are like, I was an Oiler fan. I was a huge Oiler fan, right? So when they left, that kind of goes off to the wayside. Now I still follow them, see what they're doing, but it's not like a St. Louis Cardinals stuff. I got Cardinals stuff all over the place.
Trust me, we know.
So, you know, there's a difference. That's my team. I mean, and so really.
So you have more Cowboys gear than you do Titans gear.
I guess you could say that. I have a hat but the Cowboys
That's
are the team that I know the most about.
It's
because I follow them daily.
It's your team. You come out of the closet
and have been following them.
And you love them.
Well, I love Jerry Jones.
Yes, you do. Yes.
Now my quarterback, that's another story.
Yes.
It's a nice guy and all.
Yes.
It's my quarterback.
Yeah.
And if you guys do that, man, it's unfair.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He was talking about Tony Romo.
He was.
Yeah.
But it applies here.
Yeah, it does.
It applies here.
Well, because they're the same guy.
Well,
I love you, Dad.
They are kind of the same guy, but they're not. They're not.
Yeah. Well,
they're not.
Same results, put it that way.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
But same results.
Yes. Disappointing.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Remember when we hammered Danny White for not winning Super Bowls?
Danny White.
But he at least got the NFC Championship.
Might have been better quarterback than both of those guys.
And Danny White does have a Super Bowl ring.
Yeah, he does.
Super Bowl 12, he was the starting punter.
Uh-huh. May have been a better quarterback than both. You know what's funny about that? The trivia question on that this morning, I think it was this morning, on Greeny.
Mm-hmm.
What's the guy's name?
Hembo.
Who was the highest drafted quarterback for the Cowboys since, I guess, Troy Aikman? It was Quincy Carter.
Yeah.
They knew that. I think they got it right. But it's like.
You didn't know that?
Remember old Quincy?
Well, they haven't drafted quarterbacks high very often.
Just saying. Well, after that debacle, I don't blame
him. Quincy Carter was going to be the next.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, Dak was a fourth round guy. Uh-huh. Tony Romo was undrafted.
Yeah, after that debacle, that didn't work out very well.
I mean,
that was not a good draft pick.
He did have that one playoff year.
Well,
you know, every now and then you go to a game and you'll see a 17 Carter jersey and you go, dude, at some point you need to upgrade your jersey game.
You sure that's a Carter jersey Don Meredith?
No, you got to look on the back and you go, damn, you really have a Quincy Carter jersey on.
I would change that name to Meredith.
You probably don't know who Meredith is.
I know, right?
It is the Blitz here on 94.1 at San Antonio Sports Star, as we do about this time every Tuesday. It's our injury update, powered by the Sports Institute at TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine, online at TSAOG.com. Let's welcome in Dr. Christian Baldin. And Doc, you know, as the play-in tournament gets ready to get started tonight, two games tonight in the West, you got a lot of guys dealing with some kind of minor injuries. LeBron, Anthony Davis, you look at some of those injuries. Giannis probably isn't going to be ready at the start of the playoffs. Especially, let's look at Giannis, a non-contact injury. But apparently he's got remarkable recovery ability, whatever that means. Do you expect to see Giannis in the first round?
I would think so. You know, I think he's very good at managing his body and then dealing with injuries. He's certainly a veteran at this point. So we should be able to see him and him perform at a high level.
You know, I've got to ask you about tonight's game. Anthony Davis is questionable for the Lakers tonight with back spasms. And when I watched him walk off the floor the other day, Doc, it looked like he was about 110 years old. I mean, just really having a hard time walk. What causes back spasms?
Yeah, well, it's been a long season for these guys, you know, and as I said earlier, they're veterans. So they've been through this for years upon years now, and it takes a toll on the body. And especially somebody his frame, you know, that's a lot to handle, and a bit of overuse, and the muscles just get tired. And gets to the point where it just seizes up, and it's extremely painful. Usually you can recover from it fairly quickly. It's not like a significant injury where there's a big tear that you have to wait to heal. When it's more of a true spasm, it's just the muscle will not stop contracting, and it's really, really painful and difficult to move around. And hopefully they've been able to treat him well here with the last couple of days.
Is that just, you know, a heating pad and massage?
Yeah, all of the above, multiple modalities, heat, ice, deep tissue massage, a lot of stretch, rest, you know, some anti-inflammatory medications potentially. You can even do some injectables in that area. Sometimes you can even do a little muscle relaxing to help you, especially at night. You know, multiple different treatment options there.
Well, you know, it's interesting because he is listed as questionable and doesn't look like he's going to play tonight. You think that's just a little extra precaution, a little extra rest for him, if that is the case?
Yeah, I think, you know, he certainly looked like he was hurting a lot. So if he's not 100%, I'm sure they're going to save him. You know, hopefully he'll be back the second game. But, you know, it's something he'll definitely come back from. It's just a matter of how effective he's going to be, you know, either tonight or the next game.
Well, and again, if they lose tonight, they still get another opportunity. And there's a lot of people think, well, they should lose tonight so they can avoid Denver in the first round. And, well, your chances of losing are better if Anthony Davis has got a heating pad on his back while sitting on the bench, right? There's gamesmanship here.
That's
Doc.
Right.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. I think they're playing into it a little bit. And so they'll do what they feel is best for their team. No question.
Doc, I got to ask you, I'm really curious about that. And Minix brings up the heating pad. When do you know if heat is better or ice is better?
Well, they're completely different, right? So ice, really makes your blood vessels constrict. So there's not much blood flow there. The heat really opens them up and brings in, you know, the blood flow and allows for the muscle to really loosen up and also brings in all the nutrients that come with the blood flow. So completely different modalities. You know, a lot of times we'll use both now, but more and more we're starting to use heat a lot quicker than we used to. You know, back in the day, it was ice for the first, you know, 72 hours only. And then we're starting to be a little bit more aggressive with using heat early on.
All right. Now I'm going to get very personal here for me. Doc, I've been dealing with a foot injury for a while from, you know,
the free advice.
Well, yeah, well, exactly. Cause I mean, he just said something and if I'm doing it wrong, I need to fix that. But you know, my foot just from the rock and roll 10K, like 2 years ago, I hurt my foot and it still bothers me every now and then. It's not consistent, but like this morning, I woke up and my foot just hurt like hell, like somebody was stabbing me in the bottom of my foot. And I put ice on it, take some Advil, and I'm feeling okay. Are you saying I should put heat on my foot?
You know, it really depends on what's going on with your foot. You know, is it plantar fasciitis? Is it gout? You know, have you been eating a lot of red meat lately? It could be a multitude of things.
Have you seen my diet, Doc? There's a lot of red meat and beer.
Well, hence I'm asking. So, you know, it could be that. So, depends on what it is. But if it's still bugging you 2 years after it first started, you should definitely get it checked out, no question.
So make an appointment. Yeah, man. What
eventually.
He's yeah,
eventually. Well, it's just it's inconsistent.
That would be the recommendation.
It bothers me for like 2 days, and then it's fine. And
but there's
something
then, wrong.
You know,
dude.
You can go through a couple of five, but like this morning, I was just like, "The hell's going on?" So yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's quite common to get significant flare-ups of plantar fasciitis after some activity, especially in the morning. So if it's in the arch of your foot, chances are that's what's going on. And a good stretching protocol, really stretching your calf, is absolutely crucial to try to prevent that or at least keep it at bay.
Stretching, huh?
Yeah.
Yes. Things I don't do. just go out and start running, start walking. Doc, appreciate the advice. I will do calf stretches. And apparently heat instead of ice. There's so many arm injuries in Major League Baseball right now. The Braves, their ace, Spencer Strider, done for the season. A lot of people are suggesting maybe the pitch clock is leading to increased arm injuries for pitchers. Some say that's the case. Others say it's not. But when you look at the amount of arm injuries that seem to be happening early in this baseball season, could it be that pitch clock is having a negative effect on the health of these pitchers?
It's hard to say for sure. I think time will tell as we get a little bit more data on it, and we'll be able to look back at it and say, yes, it does, or no, it doesn't. I think overall, these pitchers are just getting bigger. They're getting stronger. They're throwing harder. The seasons are long. They've been playing, for many, many years. And now with the specialization that we see at a very early age, it's just catching up to people. So I think it's potentially a little bit of all of the above, where we're seeing people just start pitching way more, way too soon in their lifetime, in the early teenage years, and then going through college, and then through the pros and working their way up to the majors. That arm takes a beating. If you're throwing at 100, that's a lot of torque on that arm every pitch.
Absolutely. No Dr. doubt. Christian Baldin, always appreciate the knowledge and the insight. We'll talk to you soon.
Okay, guys, you have a good night.
Appreciate it. Dr. Christian Baldin with our injury update powered by the Sports Institute at TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine. They're online at TSAOG.com. Of course, he joins us on the Buyers Barricades guest line. All the gout comments that are coming in on YouTube are there. Although I love the Bubba says, eat your vegetables. And let's see, who is it says? Rudolph says, beer is the closest to a vegetable that Minix will ingest.
That's true.
There is some truth there. I honestly, in all fairness, I don't think it's gout because, it's not in your toe and it's not in the joints. And I do know that's where the gout gets you.
Well, it could be
in those joints.
Nerve damage or maybe plantar fasciitis. Who knows?
It might be. Who knows? Me and Tim can have something in common.
Well, I tell you.
You said it's right in the middle, right?
What's that?
You said it was right in the middle of your foot, right?
This morning. Although a lot of times since the run, when I do longer runs or walks, a lot of times it's just the top of my foot.
Ah.
It just hurts like hell. This morning,
just whack it off. I deal with it anymore.
I've thought about that, but it's it is weird. But it's not like the pain in your toe or in the joint where that would happen. But this morning, it was like 4 o'clock in the morning, and I thought somebody was stabbing me in my foot. Yeah. I mean,
maybe your wife was.
Well, she was asleep. I was like, all right. No, I woke her up. And then got ice. Apparently, I should have got heat.
Well, apparently, I've heard both ways. So I had to ask that question. Apparently, heat's a little bit better because the blood flows better that way.
There you go.
All right. Learn something here on the Blitz every day.
Extra Innings with Pledge is coming up next. Very special guest is going to join him at about 6:15. So you want to stay tuned
for
that. Nice.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Who's that?
Apparently me.
Oh,
I just found out. Are you calling in at 6:15? Sure.
Yes.
I'll do that. We'll talk more about my injury history.
Yeah. That'll pay.
And my diet.
Oh, the ratings will be huge.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. If you need an electrician, you need to go see my guys over at Hill Electric, or at least call them because they'll actually come to you. Hill Electric is available to you